The show in studio, one of our favorite comedians, Louis C.K.
Oh, thank you.
We got to do this carefully, Louis.
Okay.
We got Jim Norton's HBO show starting tonight at midnight after Bill Maher, Down and Dirty. That's tonight, HBO.
Yeah.
Now we go to Louis. Saturday, it's chewed up on Showtime.
Right.
Right? So the listeners could check out both. That's Louis. Good. You didn't put us in a weird position.
No, you can watch both.
TiVo anyway. These days, man, yeah, you can on demand. There's a million ways. Norton Friday, Louis Saturday.
That's right. By the way, Showtime, you can get it now for $8, I think.
Yeah, but Showtime's for queers. It's HBO. It's pretty much.
I never purported not to be a queer. I'm fine with it.
Queer.
We love that word.
Queer.
We can't use it enough.
Queer.
It's a two-syllable word in Boston.
Queer.
You're a queer.
Queer.
And for the people that could really put more info in their brain.
Yeah.
Unlike myself.
Me neither.
Tonight, Bergen County Performance Arts Center with Louis C.K. Mm-hmm. Inglewood, New Jersey.
Yes, sir.
201-227-1030 for tickets to see Louis tonight.
That's where I shot the... That's where we shot.
You shot
Down
what?
Down and Dirty. We shot at
Bergen. What are you talking... What is that?
It's a thing that's on a place. But that was shot... Great space to do a...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. That's great. I'm really glad you added that.
Well, no, I'm just saying I've been there.
Right. That's great. I'm so glad to know that you've been there.
Yeah.
It's really going to help tonight.
It was full when I did it.
Yeah.
When you have HBO buying your audience for $5 a piece.
With free tickets. Nothing. It cost them nothing.
I mean that they paid them $5 a piece.
No, they didn't.
They probably did, seriously. What? Go ahead.
We're going to get away from the politics for just a second or two here because it is Jocktober.
Mm-hmm. Jocktober. Now, a lot of stations do Rocktober. I mean, it's been a staple of hack radio stations forever. Hmm. We don't even know what it means. It's like all of a sudden it goes from September 30th to October 1st, and then they change to, hey, all month long it's Rocktober, mm-hmm. and nothing changes. Well, just Rocktober.
They're giving you a little more for your money, a little more oomph.
Are
the
they?
Rock department. Yeah, that's what they say in their websites.
I don't see it.
I think when they say Rocktober also, they usually say it with some emphasis.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. There's an excitement about the month.
There's a graveliness in the voice usually that says Rocktober.
A lot of lasers, Lou.
Rocktober.
Yeah, that I love. I love that. Yeah. I love the way that feels when I hear
that. That is pretty good.
A lot of echoes, a lot of lasers. Yeah. Pew, pew, pew. Rocktober.
But we're not going to do that.
We did E-Rocktober.
We did E-Rocktober where we paid tribute to our own buffoon, Eric. Mm-hmm. That didn't take long.
No.
And then we figured we'd do Jocktober, which is paying tribute to other programs. Yeah, this is very rare on the radio. You don't really see one show paying tribute to other shows.
No.
Why do we do it? Because the other shows suck. They suck so bad that we have to bring people's attention to these shows to make us feel better about ourselves and our show.
Well, that's what it's about.
You know how it is. As a comic, you love seeing another comic on stage just bombing.
Sure.
Just eating their nads. It's the best feeling.
Can I ask Louis a question about what Anthony, you just said? You did a set when Ricky Gervais came to the Comedy Cellar to see Louis, and Louis went up and just murdered.
Mm-hmm.
And then Bob Kelly went on after Louis.
That's right.
And didn't murder.
Oh, dude, that's a nice way to put it, I guess.
Bobby,
huh?
He was on the other side of the verb.
Bobby's a funny guy, but you know that's the weird thing about comedy that I've learned. I've never done one stand up night in my life. But one thing I know, knowing you guys, it happens to all of you. I don't know how that dynamic works. That you know, a brilliant comic, every comic, I don't care how brilliant they are, has a story or few stories about how they just friggin' tanked.
Yep.
Well, he was
bombed.
Bob was eating it good after. I would say he wasn't totally dying, but he was.
What before he hit the stage? What was it? Chicken franchise? What was he eating good?
Yeah, it was kind of a munching, but it wasn't even the dignity of a complete bombing.
No.
To go, I just went down in flames.
Yeah.
He didn't. It was a tittering.
It was an awkward, upsetting. You know, the thing was that he defeated himself. He's got mental problems because.
Ricky somebody, was there. He was probably very nervous.
Ricky was there, and he was already starting his face. He had no control over his face. Like, he just was flinching and had a weird smile that made no sense on his face. And I went on, and I was inspired by Ricky being there. I wanted to show him a good show, and I plowed the place. The thing is that when somebody kills and you go on next, you should do great.
Right.
It's all in your head. You should pick up on the energy and do great, no matter who they are. The trick I always used to love is when Seinfeld would come into the cellar, because Seinfeld goes on and kills, but you can totally kill after him.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Because you're more excited, actually, than he is. You're more into it than
he
is.
Yeah.
But so Bob, as he's going on stage, he's like, oh, this is going to suck.
Oh, just defeated before he got
ruined
up there.
Himself, because every time
he's
actually...
Right.
He's right. Yeah, every time he started to get anything going, he'd say something embarrassing and ruin it.
That's too bad.
The people would start laughing, and then he'd say something horrible.
Yeah.
But anyway, Ricky and I were sitting together, and we're laughing at him because of how bad...
You don't want to be laughed at.
No, not by, and he loves Ricky, and I'm watching, because also he's telling all these stories that are about his things his therapist said to him, but he forgot to set up his therapist as a person. He just goes, and I've seen him do the bits, he just goes, anyway, so then he says this, and the audience is looking at each other like
who?
Who? And so now he's bombing because he left out a massive piece of information that drives 20 minutes of his act. And Ricky and I realized this, and I whispered to Ricky, and we were both laughing about it. But then at one point, Bob was bombing really bad, and he looked out at the audience with this weird, I hate myself look that lasted a really long time. And Ricky just laughed because of how crazy that was, that a person would do that.
Oh, yeah.
That's a tough spot for...
But then so later we're outside and Robert Kelly comes up to us and goes, I mean, just does the work instead of just kind of going, he goes, so I heard you guys laughing at a point where I hadn't told a joke. So I feel real bad because I heard Ricky laughing. He says it and Ricky just turns white and goes, oh, God, no, it was something else. And
Ricky should have just brutalized him.
Yeah.
At you.
That's a great bombing.
Because you were falling like Joe Kittinger in 1950.
You're bombing in dollars and pounds.
Oh, that's great.
Let's bring it back to Jocktober. So, so that's the point. That's the point we're making. We enjoy when other radio shows just do awful radio, right? Here's the official sweeper of Jocktober.
Happy Jocktober, everybody, from your friends at the Opie and Anthony Show. It's a celebration of hacky, pukey radio shows and DJs from across this great nation of ours.
The black and the bad and the sweet of the juice, baby!
There was a lot of energy there for some reason, but it's like wasted energy.
Yeah.
It's like sitting in your driveway in neutral and just gassing it.
Like up the crapola, it's Jocktober.
There's a person stranded!
There's a show!
It's stranded!
My rebuttal is, yo mama!
I like that.
What the hell was that?
Happy Jocktober, everybody, from your friends at the LP and Anthony Show.
Ha ha.
Let's all do it.
Ha 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 ha.
There's no joy attached to that sound.
None.
Wow, very good.
Oh, that's weird.
You think there's a lot of shows right now just going, oh, please, don't be me.
I don't want it to be me.
Don't be me.
Yeah.
Well, we announced today's show. Sam, who are we mocking today?
Mocktober. Today's show is the Chrisman Morning Show, also out of Central PA, like our friends from yesterday, the People's Morning Show.
You know, it's a hotbed of activity, that part of Pennsylvania, for Jocktober.
I guess so. This was suggested by a listener who emailed it in.
Okay.
And,
Chrisman or Chrisman?
Chrisman.
Okay.
All right. And what can you tell us about the Chrisman or Chrisman radio show?
It's the show that every sketch comedy show and movie has ever made fun of.
Mm-hmm.
It's that jockey voice and the hole that we all make fun of. 100%.
Oh, we got a hole?
Oh, of course,
we have a hole.
You want to explain the hole to Louie?
You know the hole is the mandatory woman.
Oh, come on.
Involved on the radio show, right?
Oh, come on, don't.
Guys.
You guys always.
Oh, that's terrible.
Oh.
Yeah, so this old lady, she was eating she's eating cat food. And, oh, that's not very nice.
Oh,
she's probably a nice woman that can't afford food. You know, the friggin' water on the fire. That's it. Anytime anything gets going, the big sweaty, greasy hand on that brake handle on the train. or just stop any bit of fun?
It's the yield sign.
Yeah. Yes.
It's the yield sign for every bit.
Her uterus is like when you rip the space helmet off an astronaut, and it just sucks all the funny right out of the room.
It's just a hole. A hole.
There's
a vortex of funny.
There's a big problem.
Slippery sides and smelly parts.
There's a big problem in the business. Like, the radio executives, they insist on having a woman on every morning show, except for ours. I think we're one of the few. We refuse to go there. You can't have yield signs.
Except for Jimmy.
I'm a guy. You have to just go for it. You can't slow down and look around and make sure it's going to be okay. You got to barrel ahead.
Yep.
With that, are we ready? Anything else you want to add in the intro there, Sam?
Well, they have a stunt boy, I guess, whose name is Rod the Boy. Yeah. We don't really hear much from him. I think in one clip you can kind of hear him in the background, but not much excitement from Rod the Boy this morning.
It's the formula. You need a stunt boy, and you got to call him stunt boy. You need the hole.
Yeah. And you need your Gary Chrisman.
And you need your Gary Chrisman. All right, Gary, who's the host here, right?
Yes.
He yawns during Gail's weather.
Well, yeah, because Gail's our hole for the day.
All right.
Gail does the weather, and she catches Gary yawning.
That's going to cause a little friction.
It opens a can of worms.
Oh my God. That must have been so embarrassing for him.
The weekend looks great, too. Low 60s and sunshine both Saturday and Sunday. Am I keeping you awake, Gary?
Huh?
I'm hearing this yawning in my ear.
I'm a little... This I'm not starting out real well.
You want me to jump in?
I don't know if I've ever been called boring.
I'm kind of bored with what you're saying.
Obviously.
Oh.
You can tell it's Friday.
Oh, you got to be kidding me. What time is it? Oh, I don't want any part of this stuff. I don't know. Let's call in today. Let's not even go in.
This sucks.
Oh, I understand why.
Boring.
I understand why she's laughing.
Oh, you do, Jimmy?
Oh, yeah, it's funny stuff.
Where?
But why is he not enjoying it?
Yeah, that's the weird thing. They're on two different pages. Yeah. They're out of sync with each other.
They suck.
If I woke up one morning and my neighbors were saying those things through the wall, I would call the local radio station and complain.
You started the show back in January of 1976?
Yes, his bio is on their webpage. And the bio says that he's celebrating the 30th anniversary of the show, which obviously means the bio hasn't been updated in 2 years. But 32 years of the Chrisman Morning Show.
In the middle of nowhere, Pennsylvania.
Central.
God, kill yourself. Just kill yourself live on the show. The play Filling It In with a hilarious caller, what's that about?
Well, they have a game. It's called Filling It In.
Oh, my God. That's crazy.
And what they do is they'll throw two blanks in a sentence and then just open it up to the listeners and say...
You gotta be kidding me.
It's like Mad Libs, only nuttier.
Wow, that sounds crazy, Sam.
Yeah.
All right.
All right, Creative Jeff, just because I'm...
A soccer mom.
A soccer mom doesn't mean I'm...
A vice president.
Me.
She's right, though. That's not what that's about. It's not to be mean like that. Come on, guys. It's supposed to be fun. What is that? I'm a soccer mom. I can't be vice president.
Yeah, what if she was listening?
Wow. That's edgy.
For the record, that clip, they felt so strongly about that clip that it was in the podcast section in the best of.
Oh, my God.
Oh, it was. So that was
that
like
would be,
cream of the crop.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What was the actual... I don't know.
Let's see if they answer that question, Jimmy.
All right, Creative Jeff, just because I'm...
A soccer mom.
A soccer mom doesn't mean I'm...
A vice president.
Or a hockey mom. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, filling it in. Thanks a lot.
Ladies and gentlemen, filling it in.
Filling it in.
Well, we're filling it in tonight.
Filling it in.
How about we fill in the and make sure we spray some
just because I'm a doesn't mean I'm a
right.
Oh God, what? that's just asking for trouble.
Sure is.
Did you hear the hole?
That's
the yield sign right there. Well, yep. All right, I'll let you get away with that, but let's not go any further, guys.
Oh.
Ugh. I know. Oh, it's just the worst.
They're terrible. That sound is actually coming out from between her legs rather than her mouth, I think.
Yeah.
Oh!
Holy moly.
Just oh, wait a minute.
That's the... Wait a minute. I just figured something out, though. Yeah. They mean Sarah Palin.
Yeah.
No way.
Oh, my God. That's hilarious. I just figured that out.
They're lampooning Sarah Palin, vice presidential nominee of the Republican Party.
Right.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
God, see, we weren't quick enough to pick up on that, and that's why it wasn't that funny.
I'm surprised that wasn't dumped, because that was really irreverent. I'm surprised they didn't dump out on that.
Oh, we're getting info on this show.
The Chrisman Morning Show.
The Chrisman Morning Show. We got Sarah in PA. Sarah?
Hi.
Hi.
Love you guys.
You're not another Sarah Palin, are you? You know.
So I used to live in central Pennsylvania where the show's out of, and Gary Chrisman actually does the voice for Rod the Boy. So there actually isn't an extra stunt boy. It's actually Gary Chrisman.
Oh, no.
No, stop. He plays the part of...
Oh, false advertising.
In a dramatic dual role.
He does In the beginning clip.
Yeah.
We hear, when he's yawning and she's saying something, we hear someone in the background.
Ready to take over? Yeah, that guy, right?
Is that Rod the stunt boy?
I would assume that that would have to be Rod the boy. It's not a, there's no more cast members.
No.
Exactly, the high-pitched, like, voice, that's Rod the boy.
We played that, did you hear the clip of the yawn?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right, punch out, boy.
Oh, you want to hear it again?
Yeah, I want to hear him do it. I was asking her if that's what she meant.
Is it because he's stupid or is he ripping off Phil Hendry? Because Phil Hendry does that.
Yeah, where he does other people.
Has a guy in his studio mm-hmm. that he just keeps, who goes, hi, what if I do? And he goes, shut up.
Yeah.
Like he just keeps.
He was brilliant at it.
He was great, yeah.
Yeah, you got to give him props. Phil Hendry's show was really good. I don't know if he's on anymore.
He's retired. I heard he retired.
That's what I heard, too.
Great.
The weekend looks great, too. Low 60s and sunshine both Saturday and Sunday. Am I keeping you awake, Gary?
Huh? Who?
I'm hearing this yawning in my ear.
I'm a little... I'm not starting out real well.
You want me to jump in?
I know.
Is that...
That's him. That has to be him.
That's him doing it.
So does he do this like...
It's both characters.
You want me to jump in? I'll get
yes.
it. Oh, yeah. But I'm so... Yeah. Oh, I'm so...
But you want me to jump in? I'll jump in.
And for the rest of this bit...
hell is...
For the rest of this bit, could you play the part of our stunt boy? Just some... Yeah. Just even call him stunt boy.
Yeah,
Ted
stunt
the stunt boy.
Boy.
Yeah, Ted the stunt boy.
Hey, wait a minute.
I don't know. Should we play another clip? This is
funny stuff.
This is a little rough.
This is going great.
Yeah, it sure is.
It sure is. These guys were a little sadder than the overenthusiastic, like market pushing jerks.
This guy's
just old and dying.
You didn't tell us they're on one of those Kiss stations. Every city has to have a Kiss.
Dying. Right.
Has to have a Kiss FM. Mm-hmm.
Yes, Central PA's own Kiss 102.7.
Well, their slogan is Big Hits, Big Fun.
Mm. Which is what the Chrisman show is all about.
Wow.
Mm.
Sure sounds it.
Yeah.
Crazy caller interactions.
All right, here we go. Describing SNL, we learn about the show's humor.
Ah. Yeah, kind of, because they say what they think is funny, so we can kind of figure out where their jokes are coming from.
All right.
Okay, good.
Scott, tomorrow's edition of Saturday Night Live could be really funny. It's going to be a satirical version of last night's debate, and... Queen Latifah is going to play the moderator.
Oh, boy.
Oh, my God.
That, I bet, is going to be sassy.
I know. Oh. And the really sickening part is that's actually what SNL is going to do. They're going to have Queen Latifah on.
That's it?
I'm sure.
Because nothing happened. And because that woman, there's nothing to say about that woman.
Well, Queen Latifah, like, if you really need a sassy gal.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, you got to just get her.
She's the go-to sassy.
Oh, she's good.
Yeah.
She really is. But
white people are scared of her. Get out of her way, white people.
More importantly, why are they reading TV Guide live on their show?
This is Hollywood gossip, Opie.
Oh.
This is as close as they can get.
That's true. I thought they were just reading.
Guess what I heard? Flip, flip, flip. Frasier is doing a rerun where...
Right.
I'm going to play the moderator. That should be pretty good. I'll be anxious to see that.
And the thing is, I have got to make sure I'm recording these. Because I missed it last time. I was at the Illinois game and missed it, forgot to tape it.
Right.
Yeah, that's the thing.
Wow.
This is the thing is that...
The thing is...
It's going to let them into your personal life like that. They like to know your habits and what you do.
Yeah.
Big fan of Illinois.
Not everybody had tickets to that game, too. I like that fact that I had tickets.
Gary loves football.
It's all about trying to be local. These
you know, when guys listen, they're like, oh, I was at the game, too. I like that guy. I'm going to listen tomorrow.
I can relate to this guy because I was at the same game.
I was at the game, too.
This sucks.
I like my gadgets. I like my games.
Yeah, what kind of gadgets do you like there, Gary?
Well, I like the ones where you tape the SNL while you're at the game.
Yeah.
And so when I listen to that guy, I'm like, hey, he's got a DVR and he goes to Illinois. I got to be the same guy. Listen to him tomorrow morning.
Yeah.
I had a cable box, but, I used to have the TiVo. Now I use the cable box.
I hear the cable box go.
Oh, stunt boy, you just calm down back there.
I'll handle this.
That's the thing is.
That's the thing?
Yeah.
That's the thing.
That's the thing that's,
that's what one must consider.
And meanwhile, he wasn't at the Illinois game. He was probably parked outside like an all-night little gas station marked. Figuring out a way to kidnap and rape the girl who works behind the counter alone.
And then yet again chickening out and going back to his lousy wife. Yeah.
He's afraid there's a security camera that he can't quite get a hold of, that he won't be able to black out. He's a creep, this guy.
He's a bit in his car with a teen magazine in the back of the Walmart parking lot.
They keep pulling him over. His passenger seat's been ripped out.
And they go, oh, God, it's you again. Well, you're going to give me a break right there, Ralph. Your brother and I went to high school together. I'll take him to the game, the Illinois game, if you don't arrest me for child molesting.
What a creep this Crispin is.
That's going local, though, knowing the name of the cop in, yes, in the exactly. town. Yes. You know.
He's been around.
They love doing that.
Sure. At some point, they get so tired of listening to him that a cop does go ahead and arrest him for his 500th public masturbation. Like, that's why those guys suddenly get caught. They've been doing it all along.
Yeah.
But their local public goes like, just already arrest him now.
It's enough.
Put an end to this.
Enough already.
For some reason, the sponsors won't toss him.
Hey, you got some debate funny here there, Sam, from today's show, huh?
Yeah, well, I mean, they like to keep it topical because, you know, they like to relate to the people that are listening. So everybody's talking about the debate this morning.
Sure, so, it's you hot know. Stuff.
Yeah, the Chrisman Morning Show is no different.
All right. Mm-hmm. The people out there could compare what they did with the debate
with
what we did with the debate earlier. Sure. By the way, Jeff M. from Staten Island, he's pleading. He's saying, Opie, be nice to the whole, she only has 16 friends on MySpace.
Does she really?
That's not true. How can you only have 16 friends?
Well, I think she'll have more after today. What's her MySpace address?
Yeah. Here we go. Their debate material from
Add her.
What is this again? The Chrisman Morning Show?
The Chrisman Morning Show.
And what is it? Big hits, big fun?
Chrisman.
Yeah, it's big.
All right, but you got the big hits. This must be the big fun we're about to hear.
It's coming at you.
By the way, real quick, you know what hit? I turn around the dial because in a little bit, because I made a point to record it and not watch because I was working on something. So I flipped it on
at his radio voice.
Again, he's got to let you know his TiVo habits. Oh, by the way, the point I turn around the dial because I made a point of recording it so I wouldn't. I love the TiVo.
I had an issue because I was also taping Project Runway and John and Kate Plus 8. I didn't know what to do. I had a bell on one of them to get the debate
on
my DVR.
I usually go with the other one. What was that? The America's Top Model.
Oh, yeah, the Tyra Banks.
Yeah, thing. That yeah, one. Sure. Good. All right.
Well, that's the one. By the way, yet again interjecting the pithiest possible angle. Right.
By the way, real quick, you know what hit?
Real quick, hurry up.
I turn around the dial because in a little bit, because I made a point to record it and not watch because I was working on something, so I flipped it on out of curiosity. Mm.
What does he have to do that he can't watch the most important?
Working on something.
That was like, you know how many people watched that debate last night?
I was trying to hook a little toilet cam up in the men's room off of Route 380, and it kept breaking because of splatter.
Someone has the question
why. Working on?
Someone has the question why he wasn't watching the debate last night.
This was his job.
When you do mornings, you have responsibilities. You really do. Like, all right, I got to watch the debate a little bit. Everyone's going to be talking about it today, so we should have an angle on it.
You know what he was doing? Because he says he was working. So what he was doing was coming up with the way to work his DVR experiences. And you know what? Tomorrow, what I'm going to do is tell him that I was avoiding watching it because I was working. That's one way of saying why I was taping.
I need to know what flat screen he has. I'm dying to know. I need to know.
He spent hours talking to the local kid about the flat screen.
Is it better, though?
Which one should I go with?
It doesn't, sir. They're all basically made in the same factory.
Plasma, LCD.
Right, but what, yeah.
Which one's the better one? Sometimes I get some glare in my living room on the wall where the TV's going to be. How well will the glare affect the picture?
Which kind does the chief of police have? Because
yes.
I want to be on par with him. He makes $29,000 a year.
Yes, Chief of Police O'Grady. I had dinner with him one night. I had the steak. He had some seafood, I believe it was.
I got to relate to the common man. If I go 42, 45 inches, is that going to seem a little pompous to my
I don't tell him about the 45-incher. I tell him about the 32 I have.
Right, because that's more the TV my listeners would have.
Yeah.
You over-calculating douche.
Working on something, so I flipped it on out of curiosity.
Did you?
And I go by Gail's favorite, the Hum Shopping Network. The woman on the Hum Shopping Network looks just like her.
Oh, you're kidding.
For a minute, I double-checked.
Everybody's trying to look like her now.
I turned
it. Yeah, she's right, though. I mean, we make fun of her, but she's right.
It's true. She hit it on the head.
Yeah.
She is the George Carlin of that, of whatever she's just talking about just now. The thing is, he's saying what he just said, like he can't stop from, like, he's almost in pain because he's going to laugh so hard.
Yeah.
Oh.
Trying to look like her
I
now.
I turned back and I said, my God, Sarah Palin, she's not really in the debate. She's on the Hum Shopping Network.
Or you thought it was the worst debate ever.
Yeah. Yeah.
I was like, what kind of debate is this? She's selling
jewelry or something.
I thought she was going to come out at one point and say, okay, so Joel, I made you a casserole.
That's hilarious.
Casserole.
She's making a casserole. Oh, good gravy.
Jocktober is making fools out of us. This is a funny show.
I know.
It's a damn funny show.
I've been on shows like this where they laugh that hard, and then the instant the mics are off, they just turn into pieces of miserable stone. Just sit there.
Can you give me some coffee?
I hate how, like, when they want you to
getting
do a joke.
Like a Marlboro Light outside in the cold. Ugh.
They give you like a 9 on a joke that deserved like a 3. Yes. It's embarrassing. Yes. You're like, and then my plane was like, what happened? Scumbag, my plane was late.
Late plane.
Right, that wasn't the joke, you idiot. That was the setup.
Can we please hear the casserole?
Late plane.
Strap me to a wing. I'm the stunt boy.
Are you? Jackass.
Who knew casseroles? Sorry, could be so fun.
Casseroles are hysterical by nature.
Oh, yeah.
You don't even have to put them in a situation.
No. This got the same laugh that Pryor's bit about his father punching him in the chest got in 1979.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I didn't think that bit could get... Yep. Anything can get a laugh like that.
Or Woody Allen's...
I almost said move it again, I can't.
This is Eddie Murphy's Goonie Goo Goo.
Yes,
bit.
Eddie Murphy's fart material.
Didn't get laughs like that. No.
Is that hurt,
from
by the
children.
Way?
Do you want to go all the way back or just a little bit? We'll go back to this point.
She's selling jewelry or something.
I thought she was going to come out at one point and say, okay, so Joel, I made you a casserole.
Be more funny.
That's funny. Good stuff.
Good stuff.
That's funny.
That's funny.
I'm funny.
When someone says that's funny,
that's
good
funny.
Stuff,
I'm funny.
That's it
funny.
Means that's not funny. It's bad stuff.
Right.
Like, it's the exact opposite of what it was said.
I was only joking.
Yeah.
I think the thought.
That's
the,
funny.
The idea, too, is that she did a little bit of a voice there. She did a little bit of that Fargo voice.
Oh, yeah. That was it.
Yeah.
Oh, I made you a casserole, Joel.
Casserole.
I get it.
Here's a casserole with a Mo Howard wig.
When you work in, like, Nightcrawlers into the casserole bit, maybe a little bit, if you really want to go.
Oh, Margie, you brought me some Nightcrawlers.
In a casserole.
In a casserole.
I thought she was going to come out at one point and say, okay, so Joel, I made you a casserole.
That's funny. Good stuff. Hey, now there you go. There's a little improv stand-up for you.
Yes, yes, it was.
There you go. There you go. We're just as good as they are. There you go. You see? They're not so special.
There's a little improv stand-up kind of wacky skit.
That's what they do. That's all they do, really.
Wow.
Whenever I walk into a room, people yell, "You stupid casserole." Or something like that.
Sure.
Oh, my God. We thought this Jocktober bit was going to get old fast.
Oh,
not even close.
God. That guy is just, there you go.
Oh, there you
That's
go.
Some
there
of that improv stand-up stuff.
There you go.
That's just so easy.
He should get cancer of the gums.
Oh, my God.
We need a really good show out of Boston to goof on, and definitely Cleveland.
We had a good show out of Boston just based on pictures.
Yeah.
But there's no online stream.
All right, don't even say the show, just in case we could get it somewhere else. We like these to be a big surprise.
Yeah,
day.
Sure.
Oh, hey, now there you go. There's a little a little improv stand up for you.
And I don't say that to offend. I'm not,
Oh yeah, be careful.
Oh my God, she actually
was worried that she's gonna have to do one of those apologies with lots of microphones in front of her. Like anybody cares.
I don't mean to offend when I said casserole.
Yeah.
To all casserole Americans out there.
Oh, my God.
If you're married to a casserole, I don't mean to call you a casserole lover.
Casserole lover.
You know, maybe you're a size queen, and we all know casseroles are the bowls in the cuckold relationship.
I love the discussion about the bowl.
The bowl. Casserole coalition comes in.
The bowl does what? No, what is the cuckold?
Services the bowl.
Services.
He prepares the bowl.
He prepares the bowl.
Prep that bowl.
Yeah.
Preps him.
I think we're done, guys. I mean, really. I think we made our point with this show.
Is there more
right?
of this show?
There's a little more.
I think we got to give it a dang.
All right, what the hell?
Let's just see what's around the corner.
They do more funny stuff. Yeah. Sam, by the way, Lou, just to bring you into this, he's a sarcastic mother effer, and his how he lists these tracks are terrific, too.
Mm-hmm.
He writes, Sam, they do more funny stuff now with Dancing with the Stars. This clip illustrates exactly what a hole is.
Yes, we kind of bring it home.
Okay.
All right. It's all about the hole on these shows.
I bet it gets a little bit, and she stops.
Mm.
Here we go.
Thank God.
Dancing with the Stars fans are going to be unhappy about this. Two-time Indy 500 winner and champion of Dancing with the Stars, Elio Castroneves, was indicted yesterday on 6 counts of tax evasion.
Whoa!
He's 33, he's single, he lives in Coral Gables, Florida, but they said if found guilty, he could get 10 years in federal prison?
Man, can you imagine?
No, I cannot. He's such a pretty boy, I don't know how long he would last in prison.
Tell you one thing, he'd teach some guys how to dance in there.
That's true. Man. He could do that, could
That's
he?
All he needs is to win the Dance of the Stars competition at the federal pen.
That's not even funny.
Oh, man.
Well, she got that right.
Yeah.
All right. We put 1 point for her for the whole.
That's not even funny. I'm quitting.
That's not even funny. And she didn't even mean.
Like, what do you mean, my joke?
No, this whole show, I'm leaving.
Sucks, I quit.
Yes.
She didn't even mean it like, you know, look, that's not even funny.
No. Yeah.
She meant like, that's not even funny. Like, hey, don't go there.
Yeah. Right.
Don't go there. The dance competition in prison.
Here's
I bet
guys.
There'd be a lot of, King over there.
Yeah, he'd have a black war helmet on his nose.
Oh, that's not even funny.
This is the thing.
Come on.
These people, their humor is the most simple arithmetic in the world.
Wait, no, come on.
They go.
That's a great hole.
They go, a guy from Dancing of the Stars is going to federal prison equals, what? He's got to teach the dancing of the people in that prison. That's it. That's what they got.
Yeah, that's it.
Now, guys, let's not make fun of people.
Such a perfect hole.
Great.
That captures the complete essence
let's
of
not
the hole.
Make fun of people.
That's Janine on Long Island.
Guys.
A regular at F.H. Riley's. She rules.
Oh, that's great.
All right, well, we made our point. That's today's Jocktober.
Wow.
We're really late for a break.
It was well worth it, though, I think.
Yeah, yes. Jocktober is such a success so far.
Instead of doing a radio show, that guy needs to die of AIDS.
Lou, what? Now stop.
Why?
That's not funny.
Wait, no, come on. Lou.
Oh, no.
Oh, that was funny.
That's a good one.
That must have been like a husband-wife banter thing. And then she laughs. Oh. Why a cucumber's better than a husband.
Awesome.
I will,
why a slit pot roast is better than a wife. Oh, good gravy. That did sound like a rooster.
Oh,
absolutely,
man, that's
right.
Wonderful. We're excited about Jocktober. Sam, how do they get a hold of you with these crappy morning shows?
Well, if you'd like your favorite morning show to participate in Jocktober, then email sam@opieandanthony.com.
You're getting a lot of people emailing,
the participation,
right?
Is just,
just
us playing your tape,
yeah,
and goofing on your horrific show.
Yeah, the response has been huge thus far, so I think it's a hit.
We'll end with this. More with Louis C.K. Let's not forget, Chewed Up stand-up special will premiere on Showtime with Louis C.K. tomorrow night at 11 p.m.
Yes, sir.
And now remember that, and then we move on, and let's talk about Jimmy HBO tonight after Bill Maher, Down and Dirty, mm-hmm. Midnight.
Yeah, just think Jim Friday, Lou Saturday.
There you go.
Yeah.
Let's end the Jocktober bit with this.
Happy Jocktober, everybody, from your friends at the Opie and Anthony Show. It's a celebration of hacky, pukey radio shows and DJs from across this great nation of ours.
The black and the berry, the sweet and the juice, baby!
There's a lot of energy there for some reason, but it's like wasted energy.
Yeah.
It's like sitting in your driveway in neutral and just gassing it.
Strike up the crapola, it's Jocktober.
There's a person stranded!
There's a show!
It's stranded!
My rebuttal is, yo mama.
I like that.
What the hell was that?
Happy Jocktober, everybody, from your friends at the Opie and Anthony Show.
Let's all do it.
There was no joy attached to that sound.
None. Oh.
Hey, you got a chance to see Louis C.K. tonight. Bergen County Performance Arts Center, Englewood, New Jersey, for Louis C.K. Tickets 201-227-1030. And then tomorrow, right? Paramount Center, Peekskill, New York.
That's right.
It's Poughkeepsie.
Poughkeepsie?
Yeah.
Is it?
I think so.
It says Peekskill.
Well, right, it's that market. It's like Poughkeepsie market, I believe.
Yeah.
Just Paramount Center, Peekskill, New York. That's what the
right.
plug says for Louis tomorrow night. So.
You can actually see me there and then go home and watch Chewed Up on Showtime.
That's right, Saturday night. Now,
yeah, how much Louis? That's calling a Louis Saturday.
If you go and rent Shameless, my special from last year, and you watch it at home, and then you come see me at the Paramount, and then you go watch Chewed Up, you'll see 3 hours of comedy.
That's right.
All different.
You know what? As a fan of you guys, I love the fact that you're always working on new material. There are guys that come to New York, and they go to Caroline's or where have you, and it's the same exact set from the year before, and these guys are hoping to make it. It's like...
You can't keep doing
it. You got to keep working on new stuff.
Yep.
And I appreciate that as a fan of comedy. So, what was I going to say? Oh, and you killed opening up for Ricky Gervais. I think we told you that last
time. Yeah, that was fun. I had a good time doing it.
You destroyed
Thanks, man.
In front of his audience. Now, Anthony and Louie were watching TV, the Today Show.
Oh, God.
Everyone's talking about the Sarah Palin thing from last night. And you know what? She did all right. A lot of people thought she would get destroyed in this. In this debate, she kind of held her own.
But how is the news going to put their own little spin and take on it? You know?
Yeah. And the Today Show, they had to do a segment. It just ended because now they're cooking some dumb thing. Got to have a cooking segment, right?
Yeah, of course. It's the law.
It's so stupid. But they had a bunch of women.
Yeah.
I say, quote, women, because one of them was an animal.
Women. Yeah, I don't know what that was.
That was...
pull that weave off and oof.
Wow.
You got a mess.
Looked like a tranny, to be completely honest.
Really was.
You got a
awful,
mess.
Awful.
And
creature.
And I looked over to Aunt and Louie, and you guys were just going off. What was the deal there?
It's just the fact that they had to get the women's point of view.
Yeah, it was like the women, how women felt about Palin last
night. How women felt about Palin's performance last night at the debate. That was what they were cackling about.
And it's these four women, and it's like, do they really want to separate themselves out from the human race that way?
More divisiveness.
Yeah,
just
more
to...
just, no, what did the women think? And they're all, we're not even hearing it,
but you can tell with the sound off that they're just going. I really felt like she stepped up there and really showed that a woman can blah blah blah, blah, blah with her vagina part.
Womanly, womanish, women, woman.
Woman, woman, women, 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 women's issues, women, women, women. Shut up.
I think she did pretty good against that Joe Biden because he's a tough customer.
Yeah, he's not. He's a man instead.
Yeah,
of a woman.
He's a man with a penis.
I felt that she really womened the woman, women.
In a womanly, women, woman way,
very
women.
Very women, woman, women's issues.
And they're all sitting there with that crossed leg thing with the knees crossed because they're wearing a skirt.
And
you don't want to just hang out and show, you know, what's the damage that's going on under there.
Four hens.
Oh, just
four
cackling.
Of them. Like, you need four of them to explain
four
this.
Women's point of view.
Yeah. What about you, woman? Oh, well, I thought that women, too. That's interesting.
Yes, because it was a woman, women, woman.
Yeah.
And it's like, why not just look at it like, okay, here's the vice presidential candidate.
Yeah, and here's what happened. Here's some people talking about it.
And here's the debate. But they gotta, like, why aren't they talking about, you know, hey, that glass ceiling and, you know, let's get all on even footing here as far as the workplace goes and all this other stuff. And then, right away, the news just has to get four cackling bitches out there to get that point of view.
Hey, they didn't get four blacks on the thing to see what Obama... Hey, let's get four black people to see what you're doing.
Look at the black point of view.
I thought that he blacked the blackity black, black, black.
Excuse me.
Very black.
Did you look at the clock? it's a little early.
What happened?
You might see that about noon
the
news.
You're right.
The blackity black black.
I thought the blackity black very black, and I feel that black could be black that he blacked. That's what I think.
Black black black
blackity black.
Blackity black. I'm gonna take this opportunity to do what's called a little radio seg, my friends. I got good news for everyone. We have a new Diddy blog.
Oh my god! Really?
Diddy blog.
You're into the Diddy blog.
Oh, totally. That guy is proving that celebrities are all just giant yawns with diarrhea on their faces. Gotta hate that guy. What an ass.
So you're on board with the Diddy blog.
Oh, all right.
We got an intro and everything, Lo.
Well, his name is Sean, but people call him Diddy, and he's spouting up garbage that he thinks is so witty. He became really famous when some gangster shot Biggie. It's Puffy's latest video blog.
What's up, y'all?
What's up, yo?
Love the intro.
Yeah.
Well, of course, Diddy has a lot to say about Sarah Palin.
Hmm.
Huh? Huh?
He does.
Let's hear his unique point of view. Let's hear his.
He is a moron.
Let's hear what you can only get from him.
Diddy blog number 24. Sarah Palin.
Uh-oh.
She scares me.
Well,
she really scares me.
Likewise.
Look at this, boys and girls. Watch this.
And when it comes to establishing your worldview, I was curious, what newspapers and magazines did you regularly read before you were tapped for this to stay informed and to understand the world?
I read most of them, again, with a great appreciation for the press, for the media.
But like, what ones specifically? I'm curious that you...
All of them, any of them that have been in front of me over all these years.
Oh my god, is he getting tased?
What is going
on there? Oh my gosh.
Boys and girls. Boys and girls.
I just spent 2 seconds actually working for a living.
Did you hear her? Did you? I'm scared.
See,
Diddy, we get it.
What Pity's doing there is his Blair Witch Project.
Oh, is that what he did?
Yeah.
God, stock in his company has to be crumbling.
Yeah. How was it filmed? There was a flashlight in the dark?
It's like he's in bed with a flashlight and he's telling ghost stories under the cover.
No, it's Blair Witch. You put the flashlight under your face.
Oh, yeah.
Like she did. I'm so scared. I'm so scared. See, he's trying to do that.
Yeah.
But, wow, that looks like a shot out of one of those bank cameras.
Don't you have another song to rip off? Why are you bothering with this crap?
What a dumb person.
It continues with this.
Of course it does.
So, you know.
She scares me. She scares me.
I'm hiding under the covers. She's worse than the boogeyman.
The boogeyman? Well, that would...
Well, you know, if you want to go there...
Good one.
Good one.
Good one.
If you want to go there, Mr. Diddy.
Funny stuff.
Good one. Funny stuff.
We can go around.
That's some of that improv stand-up.
There you go, a little bit of that improv stand-up for you.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Sarah Palin, you scare me.
We get it.
Yeah, yes.
Who could
you're
become
scared by
President
us.
Of the United States.
Yeah.
You. Did you?
Did Puffy's crazy.
Puffy isn't. There's somebody in his world who he doesn't pay well enough and who he treats badly who's telling him that this stuff is great.
That's great.
He That's needs someone on. To just. He needs not be scared to tell the
truth. He has somebody going, that's funny.
Diddy, those blog things you be doing, that's the bomb.
Are you funnier than all them comedian people?
I seen them blogs. They ain't funny, man. Yeah, dog, you funny.
His blogs
stinks.
What bores most entertainers are.
He's a dumbass.
We're going old school really fast. The Warrior, check it out. Yes, Warrior.
The Warrior. The Warrior says Diddy has no talent.
The Warrior.
You don't have the voice, though.
Warrior says.
Warrior says.
Diddy, not funny.
These guys are good at what
Hulk
they do.
Hulk Hogan, not funny.
I remember years ago when I was working on Chris Rock's show and he was on being interviewed.
Yeah.
And he kept saying, kept bragging about how he's I'm not just a musician. I'm the CEO of P. Diddy, whatever his company is. Mm-hmm. And he kept saying that. And I realized that he had probably just opened a Lonot Corporation.
Right.
When you work in entertainment and you get paid as a contractor, your accountant eventually sits you down and goes, you know, you should probably open a, you know, you should probably make a company.
Yeah.
Anybody does this.
Mm-hmm.
People, you can do, any individual can do this. But so it's just a, oh, okay, so it's my own company? Yeah, it's your own company. It's you, but it's a company so that you pay taxes differently. So what do you want to be? You want to be the president or the CEO, you know, the CEO, whatever. Well, I'm the CEO. Yeah, I'm a CEO also.
Yeah.
It's nothing.
Yeah, it doesn't.
I'm the CEO. And then he came on Chris Rock's show. I'm the CEO of Pete. I'm just like Bill Gates. No, you're not.
No.
Not even
you're
close.
Nothing like
you're
him.
You're a CEO because you called yourself one because anyone can do that.
When I sign papers, and we have to sign on behalf of our corporations, I have to sign... Anthony Cumia, and then title, I have to put president on
I put
on
president
there. I am the president of my company. That does not mean I'm the president of a company.
You know what, you
it
know
means
what,
that legally I have to write that down.
You're the president of your taxes.
Right, I'm the president of my taxes.
That's all you are.
We got to tell the listeners that you are listening to three CEOs.
Oh, yeah.
That's right.
Isn't Jimmy a CEO?
Of course I am.
Yeah. Jimmy's a CEO. There's no more CEOs.
Three CEOs and one imperial wizard.
Yeah. I did choose a different title. Oh, that's funny.
Oh, yeah.
That's good stuff.
That's good stuff. Oh, golly gee. Wow. So we want a little more respect. You're listening to three CEOs.
Yeah, actually, friend. Steve from Bayshore has it right. I do sign Anthony Cumia, Fuhrer.
Yeah.
I have to put that down. I'm the Fuhrer.
Wouldn't
that be great? Fuhrer.
You can do it if you want.
I'm the Fuhrer of my corporation. There.
It's the only one that knows what that dot dot means over some of those letters.
I know what it means.
Mm-hmm. He's got an umlaut over his...
umlaut.
How great are we that we went from shock jocks to CEOs? Who else gets to do that in this
Look
world?
Look at us.
Yep. Let's get past this Diddy thing a little more.
Did you hear the answer? To that question, did you hear?
We got it. Take a 10-year-old movie reference.
President. Boys and girls, vote, please, please. I beg you. I'm not coming out the covers. Sarah Palin can't. If I stay underneath the covers, she won't become president.
We got the trouble.
Yes, you're just showing people that you're
you
not even...
Registered.
He's making me want to put that white sheet to a better use.
It's a person. There's a person stranded. There's a person stranded.
He sure is stranded. Very good, Anthony. Very.
There's no difference between him and a 17-year-old girl, because there's 17-year-old girls have vlogs.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
on YouTube that are exactly the same amount of thought and content as this piece of garbage human being.
That was terrible.
Who's wasting America's time with his zero intellect or creativity.
All right, there you go.
Yeah, why? And he's in his bed. He's like in his bed with the flashlight there. Why ain't Diddy got no bitches in there? That's like what. Like, everyone assumes Diddy's got his bitches in there all the time.
He's that unfunny.
He's like, so unfunny that his bitches left.
They're like, look, I enjoy your mansion and your jet, but if you make another joke, I'm leaving.
You do one more stupid Blair Witch Project joke. Okay, I'm going. That's it.
Yeah.
I'm done. Get the limo.
All right, we got to jump back into a break because we got to make up a little time. That Jocktober really killed us today. Jim Norton. HBO. We're finally at the day. I didn't think this day would come, Jimmy. But,
I didn't either, to be honest with you.
Jim Norton's show on HBO starts tonight, Down and Dirty, midnight, after Bill Maher.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
I think we're going to do a speed round here. Make sure we hit everything. We did the baseball. You found the baseball low.
Roar! Oh, yeah. Red Sox fan, so.
Oh, you are a Red Sox fan?
Yeah, I love them.
You made that sound very exciting.
Well, you know, it's only baseball. Like, when I first moved here, I started going to Yankees games.
Yeah.
I'm a lifelong, since birth, Red Sox fan. And then I moved to New York for 6 months. I'm like, man, I'm gonna root for the Yankees for a while. It's fun. Yankee Stadium's fun.
And you feel so guilty.
I watch the Yankees, not at all. I don't care. It's just sports.
I felt guilty.
It's like, now I'm a Tigers fan.
Yeah.
Oh, not anymore. So,
yeah, who cares?
I lived in Western New York, so I became a Bills fan. I'm like, what am I doing? And you nailed it. My whole life, I was a Jets fan.
Yeah, so
if
I go to any live sporting event, I become a fan of that team. I mean, I went to Pittsburgh once, and the guys, these guys have a radio show there.
Those guys are great, yeah.
Really nice guys, Randy something,
Randy
I think.
And Jim, yeah.
Yeah, they took me to a game, and it was a playoff game. It was the Pittsburgh versus the Jets, and I love Pittsburgh because I had a fun day that one time.
It's amazing how like people
entertainment.
I hate people whose pride in their team loyalty.
Dude, I bleed.
You shut your face.
Yeah, also,
I don't care.
I was a kid. I was a huge Red Sox fan when it was Carl Yastrzemski and Jim Rice. Those guys are fat or dead now. So they're not the same people. Kevin Youkilis. I love the Red Sox now. I don't care. Who cares? It's like, what, if I go see a great movie, like if I go see whatever, I haven't seen
A Righteous
it
Kill.
A Righteous Kill.
Oh, no.
Just because I like that means I can't like... the traveling Sisterhood of the Traveling Pants.
Yeah, Sisterhood of the Traveling Lifts, Lou, and the Traveling Emilio Estevez wig.
The traveling wig.
Yeah, got a little wig.
Yeah, makes
me taller.
Right enough. You gonna do this again?
Now you're just doing Jay Moore, doing me.
Yeah, Jay Moore's impression of me. That's what people do now.
Frank TV's better than I am at me now.
I'd rather
Frank TV.
God
damn.
TV.
All right, so, hey, speaking of your hometown there, well, yes. the state, obviously, Massachusetts, there's a town there. They moved Halloween to November 1st, Lou.
Did you?
Two daughters.
Yes.
They're
going
to be doing that trick-or-treating.
Yeah.
To make it safer for the kids.
How is that safer?
I don't know, Anthony.
Why is November 1st safer than October 31st?
October 31st is a Friday, I think. So it's the teenagers are out there drinking.
The teenagers. They spray Nair in your hair and all your hair comes out.
I think it's too much now.
What?
We need safety for the children.
But who's going to have candy on November 1st?
Nobody.
Yeah. Well, the leftover candy.
It's like trick or treat. No, a lot of people don't have that. I remember kids that used to do that the day after, like, and then they'd have an excuse like, yeah, I was out of town. Like with my parents and stuff, and they're always a little too old to be trick or treating.
Yeah.
So like, I figured I'd come by today. Get out of here, you bum. Now you're just being a panhandler.
Right.
You're a bum. Halloween is one day. Next day, bum.
I had a friend who we went trick or treating in like 7th grade. It was like that year too long.
Yeah.
And, friend of mine did. He dressed as Spider-Man, and he just went around stealing candy. He waited till the end of the night.
Oh, good.
And he just took kids' candy.
That's the easiest.
It's the worst thing I've ever seen. He just would run up to kids, leave them crying, push their heads down in the dirt. He had just pound, and he didn't even like candy that much. He just took all their candy, and it's when I discovered something awful about myself, because I never saw anything that horrible in my life. I was lying on the ground because I couldn't stop laughing. I was like, I remember lying in grass.
It sounds
laughing
hysterical.
And my stomach hurt, just going, oh, that's terrible, and I love it every second of it.
It sounds hysterical to watch.
It is amazing. Some
poor bastard. They're
crying. I'm a bad person. That's when I realized.
Yeah.
I had my candy stolen once.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, what happened, Jimmy?
Really?
I think I was just sitting there with my friends, and one of the older boys ran by.
Mm-hmm.
And he stole my stupid pillowcase.
Filled with candy.
That's right. But I got him back.
What did you do
that?
The next year, I went to that same place, and I had my pillowcase full of dog turds.
Oh.
Nice little nuggets.
I thought you were going to, do the soda cans in there.
No.
Pulling old bad boys.
No, but he didn't come by, so I just had to go home like that and sleep
with
on that pillow.
With the pillowcase full of dog crap.
And I ate them. they're delicious.
Hey.
See rolls.
There's a couple other things really fast. You have a mayor in Kansas.
I would hope so.
He apologized. He's apologizing today for this made us laugh in the office. For going to a fundraiser, which these mayors do.
Sure.
He went to the fundraiser in drag and blackface.
Politicians have to understand. Politicians, public servants, the fire, the police. You can't put on blackface anymore and be entertained. It is funny. I must say, when I see somebody in blackface, I usually laugh.
Sure.
Not so much that it's funny, but just for the fact that, oh my God, he's in so much trouble. that makes me laugh, just knowing they're so screwed and probably have just destroyed their career.
Yeah, you can't. Who is he pretending to be?
Un
drag, too.
when he was asked who he's trying to be, he commented, un.
Oh, I'm sorry. Was that not?
Oh,
I better issue an apology.
Apologize again.
Oh. I thought they liked to be called.
I thought they loved the word. No.
I'm confused.
Let's say hi to Mark in Jersey. Marky.
Yes.
What's up, Mark?
Hey, not much. How you doing?
Welcome aboard, Mark.
Yeah, what do you got for the show today?
I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
Quickly, what?
A lot of people have been saying that. How about we fix the phone so we
can
do our show Monday? That would be nice. Thank you, CBS.
What do you have for the show? Why did you call?
I called because I hear you guys talking about ghosts a lot, and I'm a paranormal investigator.
No, you're not.
I run a group called North Jersey Paranormal Research.
Do you?
And we go around to people's homes and investigate.
And rip them off.
Yeah, what are you guys called? We've never found anything.
Yeah, first of all, we weren't talking about ghosts a lot.
Well,
So you're talking about, chimney sweeps. I run a chimney cleaning company. We didn't mention chimney sweeps. Yeah, it was the blackface. What did
they all just have soot on there.
Where is the
just cleaning the chimney?
Where's the proof? Why isn't it all over the news and people going, "Oh my God, that is conclusive proof of paranormal phenomenon"?
Right. Because you know what? I really don't think we have. I'll be honest with you. There's no conclusive proof. There are a lot of experiences. We have people that have dealt with things in their homes that really scare them. They call us in. We come in, and we try to look for rational explanations.
You ever been slimed?
No slime. And I keep my proton pack.
You ever cross the beams? Or do you just sword fight with your professional paranormal investigator friends?
No, I don't do that. No, what we do is we go in with regular...
Yes, you do.
Cross the streams, and you get a belly button full.
Doesn't know why he's laughing.
Yeah,
no.
Not that kind of group. Not that kind of group.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, you're a bunch of queers.
Exactly. And you find nothing but pain in your rump. That's what you find. There's a ghost back there. Oh, that's just Pete. A ghost is grabbing my hips.
This is a funny thought. Is a bunch of guys who are in denial that they're gay. They think they're doing paranormal research. All right, try that one. Try the one where you rub it on my face. See if that finds a ghost.
It's just an excuse.
No ghosts there.
I got slimed. Oh.
No ghosts there.
Yeah, it's just like... they absolutely think they're searching for ghosts.
Yes.
And it's just completely gay.
You know what it is? Why are you putting that in there? Because it's ghost bait. Let me leave this.
What it
let
is.
Me leave this in here. It's ghost.
Maybe
bait.
This ghost will be afraid of me with a cowboy hat and nothing else.
Chaps.
Maybe if I shave down there, the ghost will be afraid. That'll help find a ghost.
Yeah. Ghost like a man in assless chaps. Yes. On a Cialis.
This that'll guy help to root him out.
This guy mentioned his little company. I'm sure other people are listening and going, "What happened? Like, now we're all gay." Yeah. Like, what? How did that happen?
Thanks a lot, Dick.
Thanks for calling the show.
You shouldn't have called that show. Now we're gay.
Now that's what we do.
Yeah. We go in the houses and have gay sex with each other, trying to find ghosts.
That's hilarious.
They said that we
you
do...
call this company. They come over and they just start doing each other on the floor. What are you doing? Oh, this very scientific, ma'am.
You'll never understand
give
why we
minute.
Do this.
It's how we remain gay and stay in our marriages.
Yes.
Is by saying it's paranormal research.
Let's go to Mike in Florida. Mikey.
As long as what's wrong with the ghosts we got?
They spoke pretty good.
Cause
Patrick Swayze.
What's some of those other ghosts we got?
Ricky Gervais, Ghost Town, Beetlejuice, Casper, Ghost Dad.
Snuffleupagus. It's kind of a ghost, only Big Bird could see him.
Oh, that's true.
James in Massachusetts. James.
You know what? If they're not fixed Monday, oh, yeah. There'll be a sledgehammer in studio to take care of the problem.
I wouldn't even know what to break for the phones. Like, you hit the monitor.
Whatever.
We'll yeah, be. Damn you. You hit the monitor. Well, it didn't really do anything for the phone.
Bring in an old lady and call her Ma Bell and knock her teeth out. It would just be fun to do, even if they do work. For no reason.
Whoever's running this radio station, do something. Please. Just do something.
Just get that Lily Tomlin operator character.
Yeah. Yes.
May I connect you?
Is this the party to whom I'm speaking? Hysterical. She's playing an operator.
Yeah, you know. James said that the reason they moved to Halloween, by the way, was because of traffic.
Traffic.
Friday night, 5 to 7, when the kids are out doing their thing. A lot of traffic.
How come no one cared about us?
Yeah.
We were the least cared about children in the entire history of the United States of America.
Yep.
Go out and play.
Go out. Get
just
out of here.
Just get out of the house.
Get out of here. Go
I was told
street.
To just leave.
Me too.
Leave your house. And just walk around with strangers.
Do whatever it is you do.
Yeah, I don't know what it is.
Maybe I'll see you later.
And when I come home, I'm not even going to ask what you did today.
Nope.
You could do anything. Go ride your bike.
We just
no helmets, no knee pads, no nothing. You're just riding in traffic. Yeah. Mm.
Go find a dead cat.
Poke it with a stick for a while with your friends.
Yeah.
Dig holes in the woods.
Steal lots of things from CVS.
Right, go on a shoplifting sprees.
Steal like 5 giant Hershey's special candy bars from CVS and sit behind it gobbling chocolate till you feel sick, and then a retarded girl walks by and you show her your penis.
Right, why wouldn't you?
That was a typical afternoon for me.
I could bring knives to school. You used to bring knives to school. Like, you could have a buck knife on your belt.
Mm-hmm.
And just, you know, what do you need it for? I'm going to clean out my nails or, you know, I'm just going to carve my name in something. But the teacher could see you brought a knife to school.
Yeah.
Now, like, you'd get pounced on by the cops. They drag you off.
Suspended.
You'd have to go to therapy as why anger management or something because you brought a knife to school.
I once bought a starter pistol from a kid in school.
A
starter pistol that shot blanks.
Yeah, it makes
and
it...
tear gas, little tear gas
right,
pellets.
The tear gas pellets. I remember those
and
guns.
I bought it. I was in 7th grade. Okay, 12 years old. And I bought the starter pistol from my friend. And I brought it to school. And I pulled it on some kid, like, pointed it at his head. And so it got obviously taken away. And the vice principal had it, and I just wanted it so bad. I wanted to keep, I just loved it.
Yeah.
So he said, I'm not giving this back. And I go, no, it belongs to my coach, my track coach. It's a starter pistol. And I told him I would give it back. He let me borrow it. Yeah. And the vice principal was like, what track coach here at school? I'm like, no, I belong to a track team that's like different from school.
Yeah.
And he went, okay. And he gave it
Here's your gun.
Here's your gun, liar.
We'd all just be standing there on the starting line, and we wouldn't go.
Yeah.
We wouldn't. We would just stand there.
And I'm not going to check to see what track team that isn't the school.
All right, here's your gun. The principal's giving you a gun yes. back.
Sounds okay.
How times have changed.
What a well-improved lie that was.
Yeah,
I'm
going to
play. I'm playing our Bud Dwyer. It's my prop.
I think the worst lie I ever gave to anybody and had to improv it as I was going was we got pulled over by the cops. I had a warrant out for my arrest because of unpaid tickets. And I didn't give my name. I gave the name of my cousin. And then he ran that and said, no, this name is a kid that's younger than you. It's this, that. And I came up with this story as I slowly got retarded. Like my mouth, I kind of made it seem like I was weird. But at first I was fine. But then I was slowly getting retarded and actually told the officer that my father got remarried, had another kid, didn't want me anymore, and named him Anthony, and just came up with a whole new life, a whole new wife, and a new son named Anthony. And then I just stared at him with this pathetic, sad look, and he goes, all right, go. And as my friend, who was driving at the time, drove away because I was in the passenger seat, he just goes, I cannot believe he bought that.
That's amazing.
And it was one of those, as it's happening, you're just rolling in your head and going, oh, my God, I'm just digging myself in a hole.
Yeah.
And it worked.
So you realize it's the truth.
Yeah, it's the truth. He hated me. But I like how at first it was like, yes, sir, yes, officer. I was very sharp trying to get him. And then I was like, and then my father didn't like me. Like, I got retarded right in front of him.
I forgot I'm retarded. I forgot.
Yeah, it was like Flowers for Algernon in like 3 minutes.
The show started with the police and it ends with the police.
Right.
If you're going to get pulled over this weekend, just say you're Opie or Anthony from the Opie and Anthony Show and you'll be fine.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
Don't worry about it at all. All right, we got to get the plugs in. So the listeners need to focus because there's a lot going on here today. Louie, what do you want to plug?
Chewed Up on Showtime, my new hour special, 11 o'clock tomorrow night.
Tomorrow night for Louis C.K.'s Showtime special, Saturday. Yes. And then Jimmy's got his thing tonight. It's a big night for Jim Norton.
Down and Dirty with Jim Norton. It's on HBO midnight. It's right after Bill Maher's show. And three Florentines on it with me, two other comedians, and Artie Lang from Howard Show.
Very good. We're off to satellite radio. You guys have a great weekend.
Hold on. SiriusXM, we got Dennis from the Bunny Ranch coming over, and we're going to do some handwriting analysis with a psychopath.
Exactly.
That says it all.
See you there.
Yeah.
But enough of this palaver. Let's get the show on the road. But enough of this palaver. Let's get the show on the road.
You want to sit, I would say Dennis, you want to sit up here? Oh. Or do you want to sit back here? Just sit back here. Wow, we got a lot of people here today. We got some cool guests here today. Trying to get it all together as we speak. By the way, a lot of people here acknowledging that we've been back on radio for 4 years, and I wanted to say thank you very much. I greatly appreciate the support out there. The word got around that we're celebrating 4 years back on radio, Anthony, and we got a huge crowd outside there.
There's a lot of people out there.
There's got to be close to 100 people checking out the show live right now. And I want to thank Hard Rock Johnny at the Hard Rock Cafe in Times Square. I guess there's food somewhere out there. I don't know where the food is because all I see is
everybody.
People. Well, I know where it is. I was just kind of putting a visual together. Hip-hop.
Juan.
So thank you to Hard Rock Johnny for supplying the food today. Dennis Hoff, everyone. Very cool.
What's up, Dennis?
How you doing, guys? What a great studio. I love this place. And you got some of the hottest girls and the ugliest guys in New York in his place.
Yeah.
What's the deal?
That's our audience.
I think these are my fans, the Cat House fans.
All right, well, you just talked.
Yeah, who would like to have some free sex today? Show of hands, please.
I don't think they... Can you hear us out there?
I can't hear?
We got to get a mic on them. Do we have another mic we can put on those guys?
They're here to just watch without any sound.
Yeah.
Watch radio.
It's like TV at night when you're trying to go to sleep.
Yeah.
You just leave it on, turn the sound down.
Yeah.
Like, I know how this goes.
Now can you guys hear us?
Yeah.
Right.
Does anybody want to have sex today?
Patty?
One fucking guy.
Whoa.
Two guys.
You brought the homosexual crowd in today.
That's one of those questions like where people don't want to raise their hand too quickly.
Half a Hulk face stuck his hand right in the air.
Oh, did he?
Yeah.
You know, do you want to meet half a Hulk face? Would you do just about anything?
Just about anything.
Yeah.
Jimmy, who are we looking at?
This is Air Force Amy. She's like legendary at the ranch. We've talked on the phone, actually. We've never met, and so it's kind of cool to meet her, but she's been there for a long time. And
Amy's the most famous hooker in the world. By far, she's...
What makes her the most famous hooker in the world there,
well,
Dennis?
Well, she's done a lot of media when hookers wouldn't do media. I mean, we've taken... The Bunny Ranch has taken prostitution from guilt and shame to glamour and fame.
Mm-hmm.
And so she stepped up when nobody else would. And then, of course, Sunset Thomas, my ex, came along and we did that. And it's just grown and grown and grown. And now, of course, we got the highest rated show on HBO, Hooker Box Office.
Hooker Box Office. I like
so she stepped up. She's extreme sports. She's done three times today already. And
this guy's a slave driver, man.
Three blowjobs.
She's done. Oh, what? You gave three blowjobs today?
Yeah, I'm having a hard time with the language thing.
You can say whatever you want.
I'm gonna say, okay.
Wait, she's giving three. It's not even 9:30.
I know. I got up at 5:30 this morning. Yesterday,
it's like coffee for you.
She got this guy. She's with three times today. She brought.
Let me give this guy a round of applause. Yeah, he deserves it.
Who is this guy that you're blowing? Who is the guy she's blowing three times already?
This is a client that came with her that went on Tyra with us.
Right.
And day before yesterday. And
that guy over there?
And he's...
Oh, there he is. Right there.
Look at the size of his feet, man.
Is he a big dick? He's a big, tall, skinny bastard. He looks like he's all cock.
It's all fuck.
Wait. He's with you guys. He's paying you guys? I'd like another blowjob, Lily.
I'm telling you. Yeah. I'm
a little Fred Gwynnish. You can see that.
They've been seeing each other for 8 years.
Eight years.
Friends, clients. He's a great guy. I never had a client go with us anywhere. So I took him to the Emmys with me and Amy. And I brought Sunny Lane along, my ex, Sunny Lane.
Love her.
She's like sniffing around wanting to get back and touching the fire, right?
Yeah.
I brought Sunny Lane and we went to the Fox Reality Awards also.
He's been a customer for 8 years.
Eight years.
How sick
Lee Whiteside from Chicago, folks. Give it to him. He drives me to the ground, man. He's just working
how
me out.
How sick of his cock are you at this point?
I like it.
Yeah.
I like it.
And he's fucking or just sucking dick? What are you doing?
Everything.
Oh, yeah?
Everything.
With him? Yeah. Wow.
We had 5 minutes to go out the door, and I just pulled these
pants off. What's his story, though? Like, what? He's got a mic, right? What's your story, dude? Married or anything?
No.
Married man, Mr. Grady? Oh, divorced 20 years.
Yeah,
I must
just a lonely single guy.
And then what happened after the divorce? Like, you couldn't just go out. I'm not saying you couldn't just not like you're the last fucking resort or anything like that. But like, what could you? Were you dating? Were you fucking other girls?
Yeah, for a while. But
and then what happened? Like that drove you to the Bunny Ranch.
Drove you to the Bunny Ranch. Well, you know, most women have a hidden agenda.
Yeah,
it's
not very hidden, to tell you the truth.
Well, her agenda's right up front. It's easy to deal with.
Yeah, the vagina.
Three blowjobs today. How much have you spent now by 9:30 this morning?
Discuss that.
Well, could you give us like a hint, Dennis?
It's kind of a package deal.
You got a package deal going.
Yeah. Go.
She puts this package in her mouth, and that's the deal.
But it's 5 digits.
5 digits.
Yeah,
part
of the deal.
Wait,
five digits.
I know what that is.
Where's the decimal?
10 G's. It's probably low 5 digits, I would imagine. Right?
No, high.
High 5 digits.
But for how long?
Look at me.
What did you do for a living?
Tuesday, 5 days.
Yeah, where did you amass your wealth, sir? You were divorced, so somebody fucking took a lot of it.
Yeah, we're tearing through it. That's shit.
20 years. Yeah. Some money back out of it.
Wait.
See, that's the thing about it.
But you're spending some big bucks. Like, where's the money coming from?
That's what I'm curious about.
Oh, I inherited economics some money.
Huh?
Not a lot. I inherited a little bit of money.
Oh.
I bet your grandma's happy that you're spending you're throwing it in this woman's mouth.
on the deathbed, please make sure this goes to a good cause. Yeah, my cock. That's great.
And that's exactly what I'm doing.
Good for you.
My mother would be so proud.
Good.
His sister loves the idea.
His sister?
She's stoked. She's like,
really?
Have fun.
Yeah. Do you see other girls, too? Where do you live, Chicago?
Yeah, south of Chicago.
Okay, so you know Amy's in Nevada.
Hey there.
Do you see other girls when you're out there?
In Chicago, Well, not in a sexual relationship, no. It's too complicated.
No.
Complicated? Here. Oop. Bye.
No. I think Jimmy's talking about hookers in Chicago.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, no. You don't live in Chicago. I live south of Chicago.
Okay, well, there.
Where baddest part of town?
South side.
Pardon me?
Yeah, it blows the whole thing out of the water. It's the south part of Chicago.
Yeah.
You know, he's so, I can't tell you, there's millions of guys out there that just got burned in divorces, that just hate in life.
Oh, really? It never happened.
Exactly. I mean, I'm in L.A. a lot, and if you're in L.A., I guarantee you, if a chick's talking to you, her girlfriend's out talking to the valet parker, find out what you're driving. You know, that's just reality.
Yeah.
And at the Bunny Ranch, the beauty of it, it's just real. It's real. They want money. You want to have a good time.
Mm-hmm.
Let's get down. And guess what? They're not going to call you tomorrow. And they're not going to have your kid. You know, people are always saying, why do the rock stars and the rappers and everybody come there? The girls aren't getting pregnant. They're not giving them diseases. One out of four girls in America now, 14 to 22, has chlamydia. That's the reason to come.
We
got to
get these numbers up, people. Come on. Yeah. Wow. America's known for number one. I don't like this fucking one out of...
Yeah, Turkey's got like... Jesus. Now, Dennis, one in one.
Chlamydia.
Let's get right into this. So she would do just about anything? Has she met half a Hulk face yet?
You guys send contest winners out to us. That, I mean, you're just... And,
You know,
maybe a rough crowd. These guys got a rough crowd.
It's a rough crowd.
Yeah, but
wait. What was wrong with our listeners? We sent out I got to hear this.
I'd love to know.
Yeah, we sent a couple of miserable married guys out there, I believe.
Yeah. They were so bad.
What was the problem?
They were so bad.
I didn't know she was the one that was with the guys we sent out
there.
Amy's
the middle of everything. Amy is extreme sports.
Yeah.
You know, she takes and does some crazy stuff. Wherever you're at sexually, I don't care if you know 227 positions, she's going to show you three more.
I'll be honest. I got three quarters of a rod. There's something about Amy's vibe is really fucking sexy.
Yeah.
She's just,
I'm hornier. I'm loaded for bait right now, too.
Oh, yeah? Loaded for bait isn't a good word to use if you're going to be using your pussy.
You have to hunt for the bait before you use it.
I'm loaded for bass.
Let me just tell you one thing. I did a TV show a few years ago, 4 or 5 years ago.
Called The World's Worst Shirts?
Yeah. The Tin Man's a customer.
It's a bit sparkly there, Dennis.
Yeah, it is.
It's a bit
for the radio audience.
That shirt's a little queer.
This is a guy who's banging hot chicks every day, and he's
fine. Join the club.
But you didn't have to take the disco ball off the ceiling and make it into a shirt.
With that shirt. That's the whole point.
That is true.
Yeah, the whole point is wear this shirt, you'll still get anything you want.
And Amy at the Waldorf, we've done a TV show. And afterwards, these two start getting down, and they drag me into the party. So every time one of them would have an orgasm, I'd take a Sharpie and put a mark on the wall.
Okay? Yeah.
42 orgasms between her and this other chick, and it cost me $2,600 to replace the wallpaper of that room at the Waldorf.
That many times, huh?
She is the machine, I'm telling you.
That's great.
Well, I want to introduce Half Hulk Face to you guys.
Half Hulk
Face? Half a Hulk Face. See, one half is fine.
Wow, what...
How are you doing today?
What pills are you on?
You think if you put his chin in your mouth, it'll stiffen up and kind of... The whole face will just go up and be normal.
I guess they're pretty strong, like, muscles. We can try and straighten.
He's got, like, scrotum chin, but...
What a fucking pro she is, though. She just looked at him.
Oh, yeah.
No offense, you know, but most people see you and then they run.
Yeah.
True.
No, none taken. No, Jimmy, none taken.
But she was like...
He just looks really bored, that's all. All
right, hold on. I gotta jump in here. For the newbies out there, Half a Hulk Face... has a extremely droopy right side of his face. It's a big
one half is fine.
Yes, and the tumor is just taking over the right side. His ear is way down where your Adam's apple
is it a tumor?
Would be.
Yeah, he looks like he's standing on the event horizon of a black hole.
Oh my god!
I think he looks good for sideways 69.
Exactly.
Oh,
sideways 69.
He's got a position for everybody.
Well, you know, if look at everybody everybody looks the same dog style.
Oh, hey, you know something?
Yeah. That's actually not true.
That's a great way to think
some
about
people
it.
Think greasy about it. Backs.
Yeah.
Well,
so it's got upper fucking pube fat that's banging against an ass.
I guess people have like scars from chains that hit them in their back.
Yeah, just shoulders. Never know. Maybe people do look a little different.
Is your penis normal?
Yeah.
What are you packing there?
Six.
Six.
Jesus.
God, just couldn't give him a fucking break.
Give the guy 11, a break.
I'd be like, oh, yeah. It all comes out in the water.
Yeah, because then the girl's not going to look up and, you know, God's often, an right? Jesus, God is an asshole.
God's really. A fucking
I'm,
douche.
I'm with you.
But, you know, I think, Amy, correct me if I'm wrong here, but isn't it more about people's personalities and things?
Totally. It's all attitude. It's all about attitude.
It's attitude.
You know, as long as you get the worst thing that's ever going to happen, if you make it funny, then it's just funny.
Half a hulk face looks like everyone feels when they're getting root canal. Like, that's how you feel like when you're sitting in the chair.
Yeah, yeah, and you feel your face, and your mouth is all fucked up.
It's kind of like feel like that.
Let me ask you, how many times have you been stopped for stealing in the softball store?
Oh, remember when he used to come in here and he wouldn't take these jokes? Remember how angry he was? He's turned the corner.
He
goes
like
with
him.
It now. Yeah, absolutely.
He knows we like him and we want to get his dick wet.
Actually, I got some news for you guys. I might be having a surgery within probably the next month or so.
You said that a year ago.
You did say that last year.
You said that a year ago.
I go back to the doctor next Wednesday for MRI. Then the following Monday, I see a plastic surgeon. So
Yeah, well,
Dr. Smith and Wesson.
Dennis. Here's Dr. Amy.
Dr. Amy? Dr.
Here,
Amy.
Yeah, let me do a little physical before you get your...
Is there a mic on out there or no?
Wait, Amy is now kind of...
I'm going to see if it's true.
She's doing rubbing the front of his penis.
She's rubbing both sides of his penis.
Right, if you're thinking of his face.
That's not a good sign if she's rubbing the entire front of your pants trying to figure out which side you hang to.
You hope the cock hangs left, it will balance out the fucking chin hanging right.
Right.
Yeah. He looks like the picture on the package of Big League Chew.
All right, wait, we got...
Yes, he does!
Wait, we got something going on.
Very good, Danny. Very good.
Oh, that was a damn good one.
That was a Danny.
Holy shit.
He can sue that company for...
Oh,
all right,
shit.
We got something going on here.
Uh-oh.
Wow. She's got her boobies out. And half-hulk face.
Half-hulk face is going to put his face between the tits.
She's slapping the one that hangs down. I think she's going to get it back in shape.
Right between.
She's slapping the tumor.
Oh, my God.
What a pro.
It's not the tumor.
It's not the tumor.
She's
hit the tumor.
She's getting rough with the tumor.
Yeah.
Wow.
She's sticking a tit in his mouth.
We'll fix this.
Half-hulk is hoping to swallow one of those boobs to even out his face.
What are you doing? You're pinching it like it's some kind of fucking tit. She's fucking with his face really bad.
Half-hulk
face. Does that hurt?
Stick
your
tongue out, baby.
Hey, half a hulk face. Does that hurt?
No.
No, it doesn't hurt when she fucks with your chin like that?
Hey, it's a good birthday present. I'll tell you that much.
It's your birthday?
Is it your birthday?
Half a hulk. Well, it's Monday, so.
Right.
How old?
34.
Did anyone eat the cake when you blew the candles out?
Oh, my God.
Just saying, I wouldn't touch it.
God should have taken you for your 34th birthday.
What is she doing?
She's slapping his tumor, fucking putting her nipple in his mouth. Nice. Well,
that didn't really go anywhere, I gotta be honest with you, you know. What's up there,
right? He enjoyed it.
He needs more time.
Half-hulk face enjoyed it.
You guys missed the look on his face, though. This guy was in heaven.
I saw the look on his face.
You couldn't
see
him as
I'm turning this way.
We of course
the,
I did. They didn't see the look on your face. I saw the look. I saw when
we see. We see the look. We think this place is haunted.
Ah, God.
So, did you get a rod at all? It's a little nerve-wracking with all of us kind of looking,
little
checking
rod.
Your cock out.
Yeah.
A little bit of a rod.
This chick needs cock. What's wrong with you, Half? Half an H? What's wrong with you?
She's very sexy.
Yeah, that she is.
She doesn't turn you on?
Thank you, sweetheart.
Yeah, of course she does.
Yeah?
Thank you, sweetheart. He just has to get used to me.
And then we got intern David.
David, my David.
Half a hulk, why don't you sit over there? We're gonna make something out of this.
Happy birthday, baby.
Thank you, sweetie.
Thank you, sweetie. Wow, he knows how to talk and talk, that half hulk face.
Oh, David, don't be so shy. Poor David shy.
This is intern David.
I'm just waiting for Dennis Hoff to go, Mr. Blonde! Mr. Black! Mr. Orange!
You're Mr. Pink because you're a faggot.
but I would say, Mr. Orange, you're getting laid today.
You leave
come
it
with
to
me.
It's all about the pussy, right?
Is there anything else, guys?
And the mouth.
It comes
and
right back
I mean,
to
look
the
at,
pussy, right?
I'll be honest with you.
Yeah.
I wouldn't have went to school if it wasn't for sex. I wouldn't own a nice car if it wasn't for sex.
Mm-hmm.
I'd live in a nice apartment here in New York, one-bedroom place instead of the big mansion in Nevada. Fuck, it's all about sex, guys.
It all. Just ask Robert Reed. Oh, yeah.
Oh, boy.
In terms also about shaming father and mother.
Of course.
And God.
As long as nothing's going in your asshole. It's all fun.
This is intern David.
Hi, David.
Good evening.
Well,
and we found out that you're a big fan of Mr. Hoff and his TV show.
Wait, hi, David. First, we got to explain something that you might not know right off the bat. David is Jewish.
Oh.
I don't think you probably would have guessed that.
Oh, not at all.
Jesus. That means his family's got money.
He could have come in with a dreidel hat. And, never mind.
All right.
I was going to try for something, but I did it backwards.
Dreidel hat.
You're saying he could have come with a Nazi hat and you would have known.
Yeah, exactly.
You made him Jewish.
Jimmy knew where I was going.
He could have come in with water. You would have known he was thirsty. Wait a second.
Hold it. Should have been. Yeah, exactly. Jimmy knew where I was going.
Intern David, you're a fan of you're a fan of the TV show. What do you like about Dennis Hoff and the Bunny Ranch?
I've seen it a couple of times.
So I'm trying to be casual because you're on the radio now. Yeah. You were very starstruck when he walked.
You said David. You were pretty impressed to see him.
You know, we got some new shows coming out October 23rd. That's the new stuff. So
great, I'll look out for it.
Get the lube.
Look out.
Would you ever go to the Bunny Ranch?
Nobody can hear his shrug.
I would.
You're fucking making a noise. It's radio. I would.
He shrugs.
I would.
He constantly shrugs his answers.
Let me ask you this. What's your experience with girls? Have you dated?
Oh, boy. Wait till you hear this. Wait until you don't hear this.
Limited,
yeah.
Limited.
Fucking
yes.
Gesture.
Limited, yes.
Jesus.
Virgin?
Gesture. Yes, virgin.
You know, we all were once. We all were once, and it's just something you get over, you know? And it's, I think we need to get you out there sometime.
Yeah,
and
you wanna come home with me, honey?
Yeah, maybe you should sit on Amy's lap or
I was never a virgin.
Hang out with Amy just for a minute.
Mm-hmm. Oh, come on, Dave. You sit on her lap. It's home. She's stressed.
You sit there. You gotta take your load off, baby. You sit here.
Sit there. Yeah. Sit there.
You better sit down.
Sit down, David.
Don't be bashful. Don't be bashful.
No camera. No. Yeah.
Sit down in the big chair there, David.
Was he going to get a lap dance or something?
Yes, Amy's just talking.
I don't even do that yet.
What?
David's a little nervous.
Yeah. I'm a little nervous.
A little nervous. Very Jewish.
A little nervous.
She's rubbing him. He's rubbing
him. Oh. He's all red and
he's a nice guy. He's a good looking little guy.
I'm getting a boner.
He's probably like Ron Jeremy, you know. That's how
you
things
so?
Work, you know.
They
take away one place and add on another.
What's wrong, David?
No camera. You're not fucking Brad Pitt over here at a bachelor party. We want to take a picture of our intern and some chick.
Exactly.
What the fuck?
You're a creepy virgin in doll shoes.
Yeah.
It's like a ventriloquist dummy shoe. He's wearing
those
Mary Jane's.
Dangling off a fucking Otto's lap.
You stink with those shoes.
Yeah, most people like freckles.
Those things.
Nice shoes, child killer.
Oh, exactly.
Jesus.
Those should be the prints that are on a shallow grave.
Oh, my God.
Oh, God. Wait, he's not doing anything. Let's get into the... what's going on over there, Amy?
He doesn't want to touch me.
It takes a while to get used to this. You don't just eat caviar when you first restaurant you go to.
He's shy.
Okay.
David,
what type? Am I too old for you?
You said the head's under the you said?
Yeah.
Why? What's the matter?
I just can't do anything on camera anymore.
All right, anymore? There's nothing on cam. Don't worry about it. Anymore.
I'm sorry.
And if we videotape it, it won't go on YouTube. It'll be used for personal blackmail, so don't worry about it.
Let me ask you this. Would you guys, if I flew him out there, just to hang around with the girls and hang out, nothing sexual unless he decides he wants to. David, I think I might have a deal here.
David?
I think you need to come out and hang with me for a day. Come to the ranch, fly up to Reno, I'll fly you out there, and just hang with the girls.
He'll fly you out.
David's, you're like Weekend at Bernie's, man. Use your arms.
God.
She's taking his arm and trying to get it on something and just rest it on a tit.
Like Stephen Hawking.
What's wrong, David?
Nothing.
So, Dave, I'll bring you out there.
What?
Are you worried about the camera?
Yes.
All right, how about for real?
Yeah,
this fellow is. I want to film too, but he's
no
panicking.
Camera. This fellow is ill at ease.
You know, it's nice that he's concerned. He's concerned for you guys.
Okay.
For real, it's
okay.
Okay. He doesn't want it on camera. You can't put it on camera. That's going to get us in trouble.
Don't worry about it. There's no cams now.
You know, it's nice that he's that conscientious.
Yeah.
He would sacrifice his having some sex for you guys.
Smell good.
Thank you.
Oh.
Touch her ass.
Thank you.
It's okay. You're not raping her. You're just touching her honey with the other hand.
That's, he puts matzo crumbs behind his ears.
I want to touch
her. You touching her tits and ass, David, is like you and I shaking hands. That's what she likes.
You just come out.
See? She doesn't think of it like, oh my God, someone's touching my tits. It's just like,
it turns me on.
It's like walking and breathing for her.
It turns me on.
Well, Amy, let me ask you this. Do you like virgins?
I love virgins. Because you know what? The funny thing is, when they come back to see me, I've really taught them really well.
Right.
Oh.
job.
David,
Amy may be the reason that you continue your education and get a good job.
Boring, worthless.
How long would you think, estimate, you giving your best blowjob on him for him to shoot his load there?
Well, but we're going to have to relax for a while.
No, no, I'm not talking about relax. I'm talking you're just going at it.
Yeah, let's play rodeo today.
You never know. You know, with a virgin, you never know. It can go one of two ways. It can go either really fast or it can't go at all.
Oh,
because they may be so used to just relieving themselves that it's so strange and so different. It may not happen at all. But chance, 99 out of 100 times, I make it happen.
These guys, these virgins that come in there, the girls tell me that, that some of them jerk off so much that it's really difficult to get it on with a chick. I mean, the girl has to really work.
Mm. And then they come up with these porn star moves with one leg up in the air.
Porn star is something.
That's the funniest thing
I've heard.
Good stuff. That's improving like a stand-up.
Holy shit.
I understand. Funny too. This is amazing.
Could you pull those out? Could you pull those out just so you can see them a little bit?
Yeah, whip those babies out.
I love looking at her tits.
That's it.
Oh, wow. Wait, what do you think, David?
Don't they look just like you're sitting behind two bald guys at Temple? Right? Big nipples like yarmulkes. Well, I'm just thinking.
Just pimples on the back of their head.
Yeah,
bald
maybe
heads.
That's it.
Take your finger and just rub the nipple. Watch how big it gets.
Yeah, that's all you got to do. Watch how big it gets.
Yeah, don't worry. It's like an animal thing at on Leno or something. You'll notice if you rub the nipple, it grows.
It grows. Well, this is fascinating.
I peed on you.
David's very shy.
I can't believe it does grow. Yes, it's amazing stuff here.
Amy's got a clip.
Get in there. Let's go.
Unbelievable.
But 3 inches.
Don't worry about the chlamydia.
3 inches.
Go for it.
You can get your nipples growing 3 inches.
And my clitoris as well. You can't miss on me.
You got a big clit, huh?
Oh, yeah. Got a 3-inch clit.
A big garage, too.
Nice.
Big garage. Oh, really? You got a big pussy.
No. I have a nice pussy.
What about your ass?
Scandinavia are like the size of Africa.
Are they really?
Whoa. That seems possibly be the size of Africa.
That would be giant.
Some people call that
That's a continent. It's impossible.
There's no way.
Every time a girl parties with Amy, they do a two-girl party. They come out and say, Dennis, have you ever seen the lips on this girl?
I want to see them.
Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, you have, huh?
Yeah. Can we see the lips?
I would love to.
You can pull up a website picture. You want to
see
the
you're shy.
Let me see. You get to just fuck any of the girls at the ranch?
Well, I guess a lot of them I can party with.
Yeah.
But look, we're all friends. It's like you guys hang out and have a beer.
I'm friends with Jimmy, but we don't fuck more than like once a month.
Yeah, and one of us has to be really coaxed into it.
Why wasn't anyone laughing at that?
Because they kind of believe it, and it's kind of hot.
Guys, you know what? I mean, it's a very sexually charged environment. Yeah. So it's just common for, I say, hey, you girls look a little horny. Should we all go do a little lickety split here?
And they go, yeah.
Let's go.
And they go, okay.
That's really how it is.
Yes, sir.
In this environment, there's always sex.
Yes, sir, I'm horny.
Do they have to fuck you to work there?
I swear to God. No, fuck.
In fact, it's just the opposite. I make them beg. Right. You know,
please.
Absolutely.
So we're going to get something going.
We're like married couples. We only have sex on vacation.
There's another zinger. Another zinger.
But she's the first one that's up a little new girl in your face saying, Daddy likes you. I think you should go out with him.
Yeah.
Amy's the best recruiter there is.
Yeah. Hey, why don't we... Are we gonna get something going with David? You think?
Well, what do you want? Where do you think we should go?
I think David could, if he pulls out my labia, you can see him.
Pull out
David,
my labia.
I really want to see him.
David has to unzip my pants and pull down my pants.
Right. Don't touch her. Just unzip
David,
your pants.
David,
he's gonna you unzip her labia like the tarp on Yankee Stadium when it starts raining.
You wouldn't see that pussy if it wasn't for my David.
15 guys running with their labia across the field. Let's see how big this gets, right?
My pants for me.
Yeah, David, please.
Come on, David.
You really want to see this, Jimmy, don't you?
More than I want to breathe.
Yeah, you're doing this. You're doing this for Jimmy.
I'll do it.
You should go there.
This guy is a team player.
You should go over the bunny ranch.
He really is.
This client that's here, is her value going down for him at all?
He's probably getting turned on.
David, you got to go to the bunny ranch.
It's on his dime.
So you can come back and just say, you know. You had some sex.
You know, David, you can just come out there and hang out. You don't have to do anything. You want to get a massage, you can do it. If you decide. And you know what? Well, here's what happens. It's very discreet. You know, all the celebrities come there because we don't tell anybody. We're not going to tell your business. And if you do something, great. If you don't,
you know, you had a good meal. You talked to 40 hot girls and
G-string Bada for a fucking chicken wing.
What's this gonna be? You're gonna fly me out there? I'm gonna fly
you out there. You and I are gonna hang. You are gonna be my. David's gonna be my intern for a day. He's gonna do everything that I do if he wants to.
Well, of course
like that?
He was.
Deal?
Listen,
we just made a deal, guys.
Just made a deal.
What's your, when are we doing? When are we talking about? Like, when are we doing this?
Because I got David.
As soon as you, as soon as you want, we're on it.
Yeah, he's gonna be talking about Katara when he gets back. Katara, new asshole. That's
David, my Jew joke.
That's a funny one. My Jew bomb.
Let's get into this. David, take her pants off, please.
I just want to see the labia, please, David.
I know you do, Jimmy.
When it flops out on the floor, I want to see it.
Hold on, Dennis.
The size of Africa.
Hold on. We want David to point out where the clit is, too, because I don't even think he knows the basics.
Stand up there and unbutton her pants. I'm going to teach you something.
Yeah, this is a little sex ed.
Girls love that when you take their clothes off.
Do they?
Yeah, really.
Can the crowd see?
Is that what they pretend to do?
I don't know.
Some of them can, some of them can't.
So what you do is take, unbutton the pants, show them how to take both hands. You're not experienced enough to do it with one hand yet. Now unzip,
No, you're stuck.
Right. Clip and unzip. Okay.
Yeah.
Zip.
Jesus.
Okay. Now there's another clip?
Two?
Yes.
Oh. Yep. Clip. Double clip.
He's on the clip.
Okay.
Four.
Now zip.
Yep. Unzip. Five. Unzip. Now what you do is you take a left hand.
Now these pants actually fit over my shoes. Just pull them.
Just grab the pants.
Just pull the pants. From where?
From here.
David, the pants.
She almost fell off.
Her pants.
Okay, so she's laying on the desk now. Pull them off, David. All right.
Yeah, you rock it with you.
Uh-oh. Holy now she's got the panties.
All right. My guy holding Mike. Get out of the fucking way.
She probably should be. Now what you do is you take your left hand on one side, one hand, and take the panties and pull them down. I like to pull them down kind of slow, really getting polite, to the knees though. First.
Thank you.
Then I turn around and she'll so I can look at their ass.
All right, here goes David taking off the G-string.
This is real ass, David. Look at this. You like that? Pull them down a little bit.
I like it, yes.
It's kind of the visual of being right there like that. Look inside. Look right here. Look it. Let me open it up. Let me open this up. Check this out.
Shit.
Whoa. Watch out for that cam over there, Danny.
Oh, my God.
What do you see down there, Jimmy? Jimmy's head is way down.
What do I see?
Now, do you see a fucking flight to Nevada.
Huh?
I want to go to Nevada. Wow.
You want to lay back on there?
I laid back on the console here.
Just lay all the way back. Now, David, now take your panties off.
Jimmy,
now,
could you move your head a little bit?
No.
Holy shit.
Okay, I'm sorry. Where?
Now, there you go. Right there.
Don't show him now. I want to see if he knows where the clit is.
David, come here. We're going to do a little exam.
Jimmy's got to move his head. Then I don't care if it's the left or the right, one way or the other. Just
so the lips.
Yeah.
We call this the labia majora.
No, don't explain. Have him.
Yeah, see if he knows where the clit is.
Yeah, you point out something. You say something, Dennis. Let's see if he can point it out.
Well, okay, let's go for the clit, David.
David.
Okay. What I like to do to get him hot.
Point to the clit.
What, you're spanking it?
I've never been less interested in enjoying hot.
What this does, it makes it swell up a little bit.
It makes
it real nice. I like a real wet.
Looks like an
spanking
the vagina. Looks like an explosion at the Steakums factory.
Don't shake his hand after the segment unless you want to be the first person to get chlamydia from a handshake.
Oh, there we go. All right, open it up. And a bunny rabbit.
Yeah, look
at it.
It's wet, too.
It's talking to you.
There you go.
Look, it's pulsating.
What's it saying?
What's it saying?
Come closer.
Go closer.
Listen to it. Don't fucking argue with the pussy.
Come into my little chambers.
Little?
David, you got to point at the clit.
Just get this.
Why are you staring at it like that? Do you not like the big vagina?
I like it.
He's new to it.
Hold on. What's scaring you, David?
Nothing's scaring me.
I don't think he's scared.
That's just his look.
Curious.
He'd be fucking like the hottest chicken. He'd just be,
I'm fine.
Yeah, this is good. It feels good.
Thank you.
Good sex. Plenty of it.
Just let her have your legs around you.
Thank you.
For a second.
Half price. Half price.
Why don't you just take a look at it? You're not doing anything.
Oh, yeah, I'm looking.
You're so shut.
David.
You can at least point at the clit, David.
Did he point at the clit?
No.
Well, do you know where it is?
He doesn't know where it is.
Find it. Where is it?
All right, just at least point out the clit.
Yeah, just point it out.
Go ahead, David. What part is the clit?
You're not going to touch it. Just point it out. I'm curious.
Yeah.
Look close.
Not touch it.
Yeah, you want to just touch it?
Just touch it.
I can't.
Okay. How about just like this?
It's not kosher.
There you go.
There you go.
Just touch it.
You go, what you do is you take it, you lick your finger, and then you rub it gently.
It's a very big clitoris.
And then cut your finger off.
It certainly is. It's very nice.
Go. There you go.
Wow, she's moving around a lot.
You want one, baby?
Yeah. Oh, 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 oh. Oh, yes.
Let it go. This is believable. Wow. He hit the Michael J. Fox spot.
David?
Yes, Jimmy.
Comment?
That's usual. That was very nice.
Vacation, huh?
I enjoyed it.
Yeah. No,
did
you?
Did you? We must be on vacation.
I guess that's when you...
David, here's, I'm going to show you one more thing. We're going to find the G spot. That's okay. It's a little harder.
Oh, okay. Shit.
No, what you do, the G spot, what you do is you go in like an inch and a half.
Okay.
In like an inch and a half, then at 11 o'clock. Mm-hmm. And then there's going to be some corduroy there. And you find the corduroy. It's got an entirely different feeling.
Okay.
Okay. Then you rub the corduroy, and it makes them crazy.
Oh, okay.
It makes them crazy. And then the next step, once we find that, then what you learn to do is find the corduroy and put your mouth on the clit. Then you're a hero. Then, wow. then you're a hero. You're there.
Okay.
Yeah. Good girl.
You want to touch?
That's lesson one.
You want to touch it? Yeah. Another thing we need to learn, turn around, it's ass slapping.
Oh, fuck, I'm too old for that, Dennis.
Huh?
Somebody else.
Wait, what happened? She's too old for what?
Just how to slap it, just a little bit.
I'm so nervous about that. How they see that stuff on the porn videos and think it's okay. You're fucking and it's all feeling good, and all of a sudden, pack on the edge, you're like, what the fuck did I do?
Yeah, no kidding.
What the fuck?
Yeah. What did I do, Daddy?
That's it, right?
Hey, Daddy David.
And we're going to have to throw out the radio station after this segment. You know that, right?
Hopefully we can move to a serious...
David's reaction to this is she put her panties under his nose, and he really...
Try it again.
Did he inhale, really?
Yes, he did.
Took a nice sniff of that one.
I liked it a lot.
One.
It was very...
Smell like... get right in the where her asshole hits the thong part.
Smell it.
Yeah, right there. Smell that part.
Smell it.
Good, right?
He smells
very womanly, doesn't it?
It's like catnip to David.
Catnip.
That's the most response
he's losing his mind after that.
It's going to be like the Jerry Lewis movie where all of a sudden he's going to be cool. And
Hey, Anthony, we haven't heard from Louis C.K. in a while, Lou.
Hello. Sounds like a borgasm. Never been so disinterested.
Lou's great at the ranch because you know what, David? Here's something I want to help you.
Yeah,
sure.
Girls like to laugh. Mm-hmm. If they're laughing, they're fucking.
Oh, okay? Yeah.
And if you can make them laugh, you can sleep with them, right? Right, Lou?
Yeah, sure. Gotcha. I'm with you on that,
buddy.
Whatever
you say.
It's a science.
Thank you.
Real science.
Are you gonna come see me?
Norton, are you thinking about when we were in Vegas?
Good.
Yeah.
Do you guys know that?
David, just go soon.
I would like
might
to
be
go
dead
to the
by
ranch,
spring.
What'd you say?
I would like to go to the ranch.
Yeah.
Can we, guys, let me ask you this. Could yes, Norton sir. Come out with David?
I would love for Norton to do that because he could probably convey the story better than shrugging David to how David was. Because I've seen the show.
No, you spent like $20,000 sending him there. And you come back and he's like,
what
happened?
It was fun. He'd be in a six-girl orgy.
Because I know there's that whole area where you just kind of hang out at the bar, kind of get a couple of drinks in you, something like that, and the girls are all around. And there's no pressure. It's not like, you know, you're in a bar where you're going to get rejected or something. You go up to these girls, and next thing you know, you're fucking.
It's the best singles bar in the world. The odds are real good for you, Dan.
Yeah. Hey, can we see if he got any action? I mean, he just saw a lot of stuff and did a lot of things.
I'm seeing something new.
Get over there, David.
Get a little closer.
David, get a little closer. Let her test you out a second there.
No, that's not.
That's his wallet. Camera.
Your wallet?
That's his Jewish wallet.
What are you pulling? Oh, yeah, look, he pulled her hand away real quick. Get away from my wallet. Jesus, David, don't worry. She's not trying to fucking lift it from you. She wants to feel your cock.
That's right. And you know, the beauty of David
anything
is
there?
You come out
literally.
There.
Yeah?
Yeah, about 4 inches.
Yeah.
He's not hard, though.
Not hard.
So, not at all?
Well, slow down.
That's good. It'll be a nice little grower.
Yeah, grower, not a shower.
Yeah, we'll get
right?
you out there, get a few drinks, a little lap dances, hang out. We'll have dinner. I'll have some girls naked. Have you ever seen two girls together, David, like a girl-girl show?
No, I'm not live, no.
Well, you're going to see it in my limo, because that's, you can't, the girls don't get in my limo. They know, they wear skirts, they don't wear underwear, and they do each other every time they get in the limo. That's how it works.
That's it. Mm-hmm. Like Pavlov's dogs. They see that limo and just go, oh, fuck.
Take the other panties away.
Stop it.
So wild.
Do they throw them out the window and shit like that?
Oh, of course.
Big fucking pussy lips flapping out the sunroof.
Yeah.
I like that. Like the sound of that.
It takes off like a sailboat.
You can just put it in neutral and let the wind take her labia.
Wind powered.
I'm sailing my limo.
Guys, I got this image in my mind of Tom sitting there cringing right now hearing this stuff.
Tom?
Who's Tom?
Who's Tom? Is he not over at CBS anymore?
Oh, we are, but not now.
Oh, okay.
See, this would be, these are just slip-ups.
He's gone?
He would have been clutching his chest on the floor at this point. This is, satellite, so.
Satellite. Okay.
For some reason, when you beam smut into the air, into space, and it comes back down, it's allowed.
Yeah,
but if you're just beaming it like from antenna to another antenna,
that makes
it's
sense.
Very filthy.
What a great point, Ant.
Yeah, that's how ridiculous
once
is that? Filth leaves the atmosphere, it comes back and everything's fine.
It's
clean.
It's
then
cleansing.
You can say whatever you want.
It's something to do with the ozone layer.
Cunt. So you went into space and came back down.
Yeah.
So it's clean.
Purified.
Yeah.
That's right.
What's with the big black cock in front of Jimmy?
Jesus
Christ. It's chocolate.
I was just having deja vu.
Hey, Dennis, can we shove stuff in her or what?
You gotta talk to her.
I gotta piss, so I'm gonna go piss.
Well, I'll tell you what.
I'm glad I got turkey and not roast beef.
maybe you should give David a little example of what you're gonna do with that.
Well, I can do that.
Why don't you bring that over? Can you bring that over here?
Yeah, David.
Amy. How about this, David? This is unwrapped. How about you unwrap this?
No, it's wrapped.
I mean, it's wrapped. How about you unwrap this, and you stand in front of Amy and hold it? It's not your dick. It's a fake dick. Just to see what it would look like.
If she was sucking your black Jewish dick.
Yeah. Yeah.
Your dick is
black,
dirty.
Small Jewish dick.
You could bring in a nice Jewish dick.
You don't have a Jewish dick? Yeah. All you got is a black dick.
Hold on, let's see if we got a white one. They're checking right now.
They don't make Jewish dick dildos
stock.
For some reason.
No.
Yes, they do. Even buy that.
Yeah, they do. They're called pen caps. Can we bring the audience in, too? We got a fucking full house out there. We should bring them in.
Let's take a motherfucking break, then.
All right.
And then we'll bring these the audience slobs in.
I'm sorry. No offense. None taken.
Bring the hot chicks in, guys.
Shove something up his snatch and go home.
Some nice girls.
See, what we do is we bring the bleachers in. We put them right back there, and we have what is called a live audience.
Could she work the crowd, maybe?
Yeah, absolutely.
Work the crowd a little bit.
She's shaking her head now.
Mess around with them?
Yeah.
We can have a little fun, you can do it in the comfort of the
He's
seat.
Little,
they don't care if you sit there.
Yeah, we'll throw money.
Pop your legs up like you're at the gyno's office or some shit.
Can I have another $5,000 since I have to work so hard?
Ah, right.
Yeah.
That's
these guys, right?
I don't know. I just had a pool put in.
Yeah.
All right. I know we're going to go somewhere.
Are you in love with Amy? Hey, did you fall in love with Amy, sir? What's his name?
Oh.
No, but for real.
Did you? A little bit?
You see her for many years. You've seen her for many years. Do you love her? Like, do you fall in love and get jealous if she's with other guys?
It's not in love like, you know, like when you fell in love with your first girlfriend.
Right.
It's not that
kind
of love.
Deal.
But yeah, I love her. She's a sweet, sweet girl.
But do you get jealous if she's with other guys? Like, you know what she does for a living.
I know what she does for a living.
Do you ever, does it ever bother you? Like, you want to take her away and just, you know?
Oh my God, he's so going to chop her up one day.
No. do you ever get that where you like...
Visor.
Yeah.
You want to fucking get her...
bitch.
Take her back with you or no?
Take her back where?
You.
To where I live?
To where
yes.
I got nothing.
She wouldn't fit in where I live.
What's that?
She wouldn't fit in where I live. She'd be like a spotlight in the night.
Why? You live in a pretty conservative neighborhood?
Yeah.
You dress a little conservatively. I could see that.
Well,
but
yeah.
Would you take her on the set of like when you're doing Ernest films, like Goes to Camp or something like that? Would you bring her there?
Yeah, sure, I'd take her anywhere. I'm happy to be with her.
Do you kind of do you get jealous that you know she's with other guys? You don't mind?
Jealousy is a very destructive emotion.
Oh God, that's beautiful.
That means he does get a little jealous.
I'm extremely
jealous.
He's
little,
destroyed.
I'm not above getting attached. I've gotten attached. Jealous. I've fucking gotten attached.
So
it happens.
I. So have I, but it's when you jealousy destroys relationships.
It's not jealousy in a shitty way, but you just like that little longing. Like it gets you out there more, I bet.
You get jealous. You're one step from becoming somebody's bitch. You can't get too jealous in with these women at all. Ever.
I think he's happy that other people, you know, take the load off him having to pay so much.
Funny stuff.
After you come, do you go like, fuck? I could have jerked off and bought a car.
No. After he comes, he takes pictures of it. I tell him to
Rorschach
test. Big old wad all over me.
It's my mother. It's my mother.
Say the Rorschach test.
Every blow.
Is that right? You got a photo album.
Every time I come, I see my mother's face.
I want to get his digital camera.
Oh man, I'll tell you what. If he ever lets that camera loose, he'd make every dime back.
Hope he knows it.
Yeah.
Fucking Louis C.K. knows it too. I see ya.
I got a picture of Norton that's priceless.
Yeah.
That Colin used on the show. We're in Vegas. Norton was.
They know the story. the Ron Jeremy story. Yeah. He's the photos.
Yeah, we got that.
I got that
a few times. A Thai porn star, and a Colombian or something, a Brazilian porn star. Mm-hmm. And when Norton knocks on the door, these girls are all naked, and he starts backing up in the hallway. Says, "Get in here. Get in here. No, I can't do this. But guess what? He did it.
Of course he did.
He stepped
Jim
right up
Norton.
To the plate. And, we had a memorable experience.
My cock looks good in those photos, too. Looks a lot bigger than
good angle.
It's the
angle.
Photography. It's
you gotta have that angle.
Yeah.
Well, I got in the angle to make where Ron would look fatter and Norton would look longer. So it was a perfect angle.
The cock looks terrific. Mm-hmm.
Doesn't? Yeah. Nice, dude. Right, got a nice hog on him.
Let's take a break. We're gonna try to do one more thing. What time you got to there, Dennis? What time is it? It is 10 o'clock.
Isn't she due for, like, a blowjob at this point? What's going on with you?
Did you get Nancy over there, Lee?
Yeah.
You having a problem?
Been over
an hour. The bathroom real quick?
It's been over an hour. Guy's fucking dehydrated.
Hey, get him some water. How would you like to have a chick like that that just wants to blow you, like, every hour?
Yeah. Wow. That'd be good. Sure. I had an ex-wife that wants to fuck me all the time.
Well,
seriously, folks.
We'll continue. Louis C.K. enjoying the hell out of this, and we'll continue in just a bit.
I know.
Stay there.
Everybody, Huey Lewis here saying happy anniversary to the Opie and Anthony Show.
Ooh. Matches your shirt.
Huey Lewis did that about 5 years ago for us.
What did you just... Opie and Anthony, we got Louis C.K. in studio!
The special's on Showtime. Hold on, Anthony. Louis C.K.'s special tomorrow night on Showtime. Let's not forget that.
Yes.
And we also got Amy.
Air Force Amy. AirForceAmy.com.
Now, you, during the break, I think you might have, like, had sex with that guy. Is it true?
Did I have lipstick on my chin?
What does that mean?
she's saying, is it that obvious?
Oh, wow.
That's suck his dick?
How tall are you, sir?
Suck this cock?
6'3".
6'3", because I was pissing. And
out of your dick?
No. I was emptying the bag. I had a problem. Okay. I never talked about it on the air. Now it is. And he just walked in, and I was in the right urinal, and he took the middle urinal, which is just... weird. I didn't say it was.
Yeah,
was
you could have.
Funny.
You could have gone the other way. You know,
go over to,
all the way to the other side.
Yeah, sure.
That's the homo barrier.
Yeah. So I don't think he's a homo.
So we're up to
it's
four.
It's the memorial urinal.
We're up to four blowjobs.
It's not even 9 o'clock.
Mm. Wow.
This guy's a hero. I'm telling you, and he's been doing this every. Last week we were running around in L.A. at the Fox Reality Awards, and guess what? Same way.
Wow. Yeah. So, America owes him a lot.
I'd say when the last 2 weeks we've done. Kid Rock, Stratosphere. I tried to get him thrown off the roller coaster in the Stratosphere. I told the guy not to strap him in.
Oh, Jesus. Yeah. Wow.
It didn't work. I went to the Fremont Street, went to Los Angeles, went to the Emmys.
Mike.
I tried to lose him at the Statue of Liberty yesterday.
How do you do that? It's an island.
Wow.
My God.
Oh.
That was a good donut.
Let me ask you this.
Goodness gracious.
You're quite the caution.
Guys, can I ask you a question?
Yeah,
you
sure.
You got these two hot girls over here.
Yeah.
Well, can I get them to make out? Can I give them $100 bill to make out?
Wow.
I'd like to see that myself, because I need a little stimulus. Cause I'm going to go get laid after this is over with. Yeah. I got some of the girls are flying in doing Tyra, and so. Mm. I want to see these two girls make out.
Hold up for a dishwasher or refrigerator.
That would be what?
God, look at her.
Practical.
Trying to negotiate with me.
Practical. Bringing utilities.
Can I see you guys make out a little bit? We got to get up here, though. I'm talking about making out.
Well,
I'm talking
of course,
about
Dennis hung. Hold on. Dennis is pointing at the lovely baby girl. Of course. It should. You know, this is radio. We got to make this a visual thing. And well, baby girl's got...
Is about size zero?
Yeah. They're cute little blondes. Girls?
Oh, it was that? I might have been a little jab, right?
What?
The claws come out there?
No, she's saying that the girl.
Wait, what happened, Ed? What happened?
No, I thought there'd be a little. I thought there was a fight.
No.
So what are they? Size
that was
zero?
A compliment.
Oh, okay.
Totally compliment.
I thought it was catty.
No, I'm in my own. I'm in my own level. My own.
Yeah,
I would say.
So, girls, can we have you make out a little bit?
Aren't you new to Pal Talk? Yeah, she's the new girl from Pal Talk.
Hi!
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God. We got a newbie.
What the hell is that?
You're from West Virginia?
Virginia.
Oh, Virginia. Yeah, I recognize you.
How old a gal are you?
I'm 25.
Oh. You
ever thought about having a $300,000 a year income?
Yeah.
Go to school.
But not.
Get a skill.
No.
Learn a trade.
Did. This is sell real estate.
I have a trade school called Bunny Ranch.
Ah.
Yep. Do you have a husband?
I do.
Fuck.
I'm sorry.
Good. You know what? Well, call him up and find out
what kind of car he wants. Away.
Cause I'll buy him a car. He can drive off in the fucking sunset and get away from us.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
He's
what?
He's
deployed.
Are you,
deployed. He's gone.
Are you coming, to the party house,
I didn't know there was a party house.
There's a party at my house tonight.
There we go.
It starts every Friday.
At 11, 11:30.
At 11 o'clock after the show ends, and it goes until Sunday, you know, until we decide, it's time to get up for work.
That's right.
I do get up to the party. I didn't know where it was.
Oh, yeah. Well, my Marissa knows where the parties are.
No. Good girl. How long are you married?
3 years.
Where is he? Over in Iraq?
No, he's in Bahrain.
Oh, he's probably cheating.
Oh.
You know, but we get a lot of couples.
They all fuck in Bahrain.
I get a lot of women that say, my husband's coming home from Iraq or Bahrain or wherever, and I want to bring him to the Bunny Ranch. And I'm thinking to myself, she's been screwing around. Why would you like to just get I'll fix it for you, honey.
Yeah.
I'll make it all right.
I bet you do.
Yeah, that's great.
So we're having a party tonight? I got three of the girls in town, too.
Yeah, I have little parties over my house every so often, you know.
He's the king, Dennis. He doesn't need another king in his castle.
Yeah, you know,
castle.
I like being, you know, the host of
the only
the party.
Cock in the party.
Right.
Loosen up a little. Come on.
Yeah, I want to loosen up a little. Well, until, you know, I get the place stocked with girls like you have, and where I could just mosey around like you do.
The nice thing is, I bring something to the party. I'll bring three girls with me.
The fuck is David doing?
Thank you, my
He's
friend.
Serving food
my
now.
Intern is David's my best intern ever. Thank you, David.
All right, hold on, Dennis. I got to go to Jimmy. Jimmy noticed that David was extremely turned on. David, get over here.
Come here. What are you doing? Don't walk out and say no. There's no cameras on.
You're not allowed to say no.
Yeah,
by the way.
Yeah, what are you doing,
David?
Yeah,
that's
the advice I give women. They say, you know, what can I do to keep my marriage going, my sex life spicy? Just never say no.
Uh-huh.
Right. Just don't say no.
Keep your asshole
open. Good idea. It's gonna feel good, and if it doesn't, you're not communicating.
Yeah, totally. So here's what you need to do.
Mm-hmm.
David, there's a little cock here.
I see it.
Well, I know you do.
In your case, a giant cock.
Yes.
This is a giant cock.
It's a two-fisher.
This is a giant cock.
What you should do is this. Because you're not going to do anything sexual. Right, you should go over to Amy. You should put this like it's your cock.
In
just hold
vagina.
It. No, just let her suck it. I would like to see that, but she won't do it for me. She'll do it for you.
Would you put that in your vagina? If David, like, pushed it in?
Why not? There's already, like, keys and stuff in there.
Money.
She wants money for the vagina.
Money, 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 money.
How about
you would put your mouth on it though.
Yeah.
Okay. So can you stand over here, David? We'll walk you through
simulated
this.
Simulated blowjob, David. It's going to happen someday. You might as well visualize what it's going
to
be like.
It's like seeing it without having to do anything dirty.
Without the awful pleasure of a blowjob.
Well, yeah, please.
Yeah.
It's like this is a tough one to back sell.
Norton, when you call it a simulator, it's like flying an airplane without really taking
the
risk.
Absolutely, there's no risk. You're not actually flying. So why don't you're staring at me, David. Why don't you just come over and grab
David,
the fake
grab
penis.
The fake dick. Now and put it where your dick.
Unzip your fly and don't put it all the way in, just a little bit, like it's your penis. Yeah. Why don't you unzip your fly? What do you have, fucking bees living in there?
Show us what you're doing.
No, Jamie, let him stand in front of you so like you can just give him a blowjob. Hold it like it's your penis, Dave, not severed. Do you not know where your penis goes? He's holding it by his thigh.
Wow.
It works better if you put it inside your pants.
That's what I'm saying.
And stick it out. That way you don't
like
have to hold it.
Just that part that's
you're
like
you're not
going to
hold your cock when
the
girl's
blowing. Just the suction
it.
Cuppy part.
Like this, Dave. Watch.
You don't have to fucking stick it in your underwear.
It's just like that.
Unzip it about 3 inches. Let her do it. Okay.
He wants to zip his pants.
It's better if you feed it to me anyhow, honey.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Hold it by your dick, David. Just here.
There you go. Look at that, David. Is that a beautiful sight?
It is.
Oh, my God. Yeah. This is one of my favorite things, by the way, Dave. Oh my God. She just swallowed it all.
Yep.
Oh. Look at this.
Move the mic,
Norton.
She took it off, shoved it down her throat, and put it back.
Put it back on. Yeah.
David, you look really.
David, turn sideways.
He's not even trying.
But it's amazing. I've seen sexier looks on a kid's face burning an ant with a fucking magnifying glass. You're watching. David,
here you go.
Stand by the penis, David.
Yes,
you're
stand
letting
by
your tackle
like it's yours. It might be someday.
Give it to her.
Give it to me.
What are you doing? He really needs to. Do you know how good that would feel, David?
I know.
That could be you, David.
Good.
Why is he holding it like away from his?
I don't know. Hey, Serpico, that's
put
not a fucking
right
handgun.
There you go. Leave it right there.
That's called deep throat, David.
I know.
That's the part. How do you know?
How do I?
You watch porn?
Get an angle on this.
Yes.
Good.
Oh, she's spitting on it.
He's watching my show.
Spitting on the plastic.
Yeah.
Give him the chlamydia slip and slide.
Look at her. Look at her deep throat. This.
Yeah.
David, that's an amazing feeling right there. Girls, will you want to try this? Well,
David?
Yes.
Comment?
It's very nice.
You made me cry.
It's very nice. Very nice. It's nice, the touching of the penis.
Nice.
To put it in the mouth.
Why do you have such guilt with sex, David?
Nothing to do.
No,
do I have lipstick on my chin?
You do.
Why do you have
such lipstick on the chin?
Why do you have such guilt with sex?
The first time.
Why do you have such a weird vibe about sex?
Nothing to do with that.
What is it?
What?
I'm not Jewish.
Your parents?
Yes.
But you're 26.
Well.
What are you afraid of?
Well isn't an answer.
It's an answer.
He's afraid of mom and dad.
Yeah, that's
so obvious.
See, that's the beauty of coming to the ranch, because what happens at the ranch obviously stays at the ranch.
Yes, exactly.
Until Norton snitches you off.
Yeah, I might hint about what happened, but I would never tell.
No.
If you asked me not to, I wouldn't tell.
Okay.
Of course I would tell.
And that's, that's the cool part about it. You know, if you do lose your virginity, if for some reason you would want to, then the girls aren't going to tell anybody. Discretion and privacy is what the ranch is about.
Mm-hmm. That's right. If your parents say, what'd you do? You could just hold your fingers on their nose and say, shut up, you fucking castrating, overbearing irritants. Your parents are irritants. You're fucking 26. Your mother should be bringing her old friends over, forcing their head down on your dick.
Yeah.
We're
get out of the house.
After all.
Is there an issue with you being with a girl that's not Jewish? Because we have a couple Jewish girls there.
There's nothing to do with that.
Okay.
No. What's he got something to do with?
Rub that clit like a mezuzah.
He wants to be a good boy for his mom and dad, that's all.
Why do you want to be a good boy?
It's all right.
Got a therapist would just go, you know what, you're a fag, go fuck your mom, get out of my office.
I do.
I do.
You know, out of my office. You know what? Bore. Amy's got an excellent point here. Go ahead, Amy.
So really? You want to get skilled so that you find the right one.
Exactly.
I mean, that's the way to win a woman's heart is. I mean, what? If you get good sex, then it's over.
Yeah,
yeah, that's a good point.
If you don't know, what to do, then she's going to be running off with Rico, the delivery boy.
Hooker with a heart of gold.
If you can't get it done in sack, it's over, Grover.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah,
that's
a good point.
Anything else doesn't matter, right?
It really
doesn't matter. Cooking,
an amazing
cleaning, or
being a friend,
balancing the budget.
You gotta be good in bed.
Nothing like that. You just gotta be able to fuck.
That's a woman's responsibility too. Is to teach you how to make it feel.
No, the women that he's gonna hook up with have had no experience, so they're gonna be bum lays. Unless he knows, it's gonna suck. The whole deal's gonna suck because these guys put such a value on virginity. Fuck that. Who wants it? I mean, what are you going to do with it? You want to teach her everything?
Yeah.
Good point. I mean, so,
really
David, you need
wise.
To
really
you need
wise.
To be the king.
Very don't you
wise.
Want to know how to fuck before you get married?
I want to wait. I'm saving myself for marriage.
You
cut a hole in a sheet. Fuck her through the hole in the sheet.
You don't want to be with a girl for the first time who you like really love, and you're just awful. Because you've been jerking off for each other.
Oh, my God. Imagine that poor
because
he loves her. And that would be the guide to making her come out of her fucking cunt.
I had three clients in the last month telling me, oh, you gave me the confidence. Hey, I found a girlfriend. Oh, I'm married. Oh, you gave me the confidence to go out and... You know, score, and so at least points.
That's true.
Well,
that's
I'm happy for
I
them,
didn't,
you know?
I never knew that, like, being a paid whore is that important to people's life. Like, in other ways than just pumping fluid out of your cock.
They,
you know, it's like,
up,
holy
man.
Shit, you inspired me.
Beat down. Beat down from ex-wives. Beat down from the war. Shell shock.
Imagine if you had to go to a whore.
Beat down from that, you know. I mean, women are bitches.
Oh, jeez.
You know,
just talk, Louie. I'm listening. I swear I am.
You
had to go to a whore to get to take a shit.
They come in there. They've been degraded by these wives, and they don't. The wives don't know how to sex, so they blame it on the guy.
Right.
And it's, believe me, she's right. They come in there, and they leave the bunny rights. This guy's going to be 5 inches taller, and his dick's going to be 4 inches longer when he leaves.
Oh,
the bed.
Jesus!
He's going to be a real man.
A real man. What do you think, David? You ready?
He's going to leave.
Broker
is
ready.
All right, we'll get the trip together, Dave.
Filthy.
Thank you.
Just feeling like crap.
Hey, Anthony.
Jet lagged.
Anthony, Pat from Munaki's here. I think we should bring Pat in. Pat, come on in here, Pat. Hi, guys.
Me and you, Jimmy. We're going to go.
Yeah.
Oh,
yes,
wow.
It's a bun.
You're
getting
some gum.
It's a bun.
It's
going to be a buddy film.
Sure.
That's fantastic.
Hi, Pat. How are you?
Oh, wonderful.
You got
happy
some
anniversary.
4 years, yeah. You got an observation here? Or have you been checking out the activities?
Yeah.
What do you got to say?
Looks like David was having fun.
Yeah. Pat's missing a toe, Dennis. Can we do anything for him?
Not exactly missing it.
What?
It's never
no
coming
job.
Back.
No job.
You ate it? No, he's got the diabetes. So he's got to go to Liberty for his medical supplies, and he dropped the box on his toe, and it fell off.
Yeah.
No, he lost it, I think. What were you eating that day? Like fucking sugar... Coated sugar?
Yeah. Frosted flakes.
Frosted flakes.
Yeah.
And his toe
great.
Looked like a frosted...
Tony the Tiger.
You're quite the tiger, I
that's
gotta
what
tell
the,
you.
That's the tiger that's on the box of the cereal.
Right.
And that's what he says. He says...
He says they're great.
They're great.
They're great.
Oh, fuck. I'm so happy now.
So, Pat.
Gone.
Pat,
that made my day.
Would you like anything from Dennis or Amy?
How you doing, Pat?
Oh, hi. Hi, Dennis. Oh.
You watch our show?
Oh, of course.
Thank you.
Religiously. Religiously.
He's like the Three Stooges here. Religiously.
Oh, my God.
He's got a million of them. Good. Well, October
23rd. October 19th is my birthday.
It's your birthday?
Yeah.
Well, good.
I don't have a show,
got a fucking birthday when Amy's here.
Should we bring Pat with the team? Should this be just like a circus, the O&A circus?
Pat, would you want to go out there?
Yeah, it's a free trip.
They're trailers, aren't they?
No, not hardly.
No, let me tell you a story about that. There used to be
a trailer. There's no bunnies there?
Here comes the story. Here it comes.
There's no actual bunnies there?
You know, everyone thinks that they're a trailer.
Just don't move.
Not everybody.
Continue the fucking show.
I just
put
a picture of Louis.
Hey, no one knows how much money I just made. It's a fucking sticker.
Don't move. Everyone fucking stopped.
Amy was going to give you guys a history lesson.
All righty.
In the old days.
Yeah, you think it's in trios, but in the
learn
old
about
days,
Cuba,
be...
sucking some cock. It's our time, Mr. Hand.
In the old days, they used to take, they have trailers because they'd move them from county to county when the heat would get tough.
Because
the business was illegal until 72. My place has been there since 55. So they had a trailer, and they'd move it across the county line. Like, we're 1 mile from the county line. Mm-hmm. So one day it's on one side of the county line when there's no heat, and they can bribe the sheriff. Mm-hmm. The next day, that sheriff gets political, they move it across the other side of the county line.
That's why they were mobile.
That's how that started.
Trailers.
That's the myth
trailer
about
the
trailer.
With the wheels.
Move them around.
Yeah.
All right,
so
I get it.
Because of the sheriff.
It's like the Old West.
It was the Old West.
It sounds like
the
Old West.
And that's why it's legal there. Because
this line, that line, this line.
So, Pat, the bottom
right,
line
Pat,
is,
we get it.
Do you like girls?
Yeah.
Are you a virgin?
Oh, no.
When was the last time?
Long time, Dennis.
Last century?
Oh, you know, that could be just fucking 7 years
It's about 10, I think.
We like to take care of the needy.
Oh.
And once we jumpstart you, you might be wanting to date again.
I might need some pills.
Oh.
Diabetes is brutal.
What's the matter? You have erectile dysfunction?
Oh.
A little bit of that going on, too?
I'm a friend of Ed.
Ed is good.
I don't get that. Erectile dysfunction, ED.
Should we all point and laugh at Pat's erectile dysfunction?
You can't get a boner. You can't get a boner.
No, you know what? I think most of the men in America think they have ED just because it's on TV and they're trying to sell you pills for it.
So what do they need?
You saw it on TV.
What do they need?
Here comes the one
line. You need a little time.
For just one moment, being serious,
yes,
she's right. A hot chick will change that. Guys that have ED need to come to the ranch and party with a new girl.
Yes, joy goes to the ranch.
You can party with a different chick every day
of
your life.
Place you can
can't bang your wife 2 nights in a row. Right?
The doctors at the ranch will treat you and fix your ED.
Yeah. It's true.
Yeah.
You know, married guys get... You can't eat... I love your pasta, but I don't want to eat it 3 meals a day for the next 30 years.
Their doctor swallowing your medicine.
Then I'll be fucking like a rabbit at the bunny ranch.
Oh, Jesus, Pat. Oh, God.
Slap your head when you do that.
Three Stooges, right?
This is what she means, is that Curly used to slap himself on the head.
Yes.
This is to what she's referring.
Yeah.
At this particular juncture. Yeah.
For the fifth time.
All right. Yes. Well, look at the audience hasn't uttered a peep.
Well, why would they?
Exactly. It's usually a very loud and
kind
of raucous audience.
Yeah. You
guys are pretty mellow today. Yeah.
Hey, we got Stalker Patty over there. Patty?
Yeah. Speaking of virgins, here's another one. She's a 50.
Patty. Hold on, Dennis, are you still doing that virgin thing with that chick?
Yeah, we got 15 offers now between $1 million and $3.8 million.
To bang a virgin, and you can prove she's a virgin, and she's, 19 or 20?
Tests, one from Maury, baby daddy, and the other one from Entertainment Tonight, lead story for 4 nights.
Right.
And so she's two lie detector tests. She's going to go through a physical if the guy wants
to. And how old is she?
22.
And when is this going down?
Well, as soon as she finds it's like the Bachelorette game, Bunny Ranch style. She's picking the right guy. Now, the offers are all right around $1 million, so she's trying to get the nicest personality.
Well, if this works, I want to interrupt here. We got your next virgin. Her name is Patty.
Hi, Patty.
Stalker Patty, come to the front of the class here.
Yeah.
She's a little older than 22.
Yeah, you're getting an average of $1 million. You probably would get $10.70 here. $10 and 70 cents.
$10.
Start the bidding at 99 cents.
No shit.
No. She'll get money out of it. She can get a couple hundred grand.
Patty, how old are you again?
I'm 54 on my next birthday, and that would be in June.
And Dennis, she's never been late.
So you're 53.
Yeah.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Jesus.
I'm 54 on my next birthday.
How old are you?
September 30th.
How old are you?
Guys, I'll be 57 in 3 years. That's how old I am right now, is that someday
guys
I'll be dead.
Yeah, she can't wait to be dead.
She's going to be someplace that nobody else has been.
Hey, Dennis, you want to look at her pussy or what and see if she's a virgin?
I think, you know what?
Patty, can you let Dennis look at your pussy to see if you're a virgin, please? He won't touch
it.
Yeah.
Great. Patty, you know what? She's got a nice little body on her.
She's
not on the same pill. 54 years, almost 54. Yeah, she got a tight little body on her.
ET's body on her.
Yeah, exactly.
Money, make some money. You've held off all these years. Don't give it away. Just make some money off of it.
Yeah. Dennis, you want to look at her pussy or what?
Absolutely. I'll go check it out.
Patty, can you do us a favor and show your pussy for Dennis?
As long as it's not being filmed.
Of course it's not.
Boy,
being
that
filmed.
Was easy.
Of course it would break the camera.
Wasn't there a time where wasn't there a time you had to talk her into this
it
shit?
It took forever.
Oh, now like, can we see the pussy? And she's like, yep. Yep.
All right, pull down your pants.
Look at underwear you got
your
on.
Your work pants.
She's got pink panties on.
I mean, the shirt up. I'm
going from.
Oh, she got it all. She got a landing strip.
Worst to horrible.
Oh, she got a nice little landing strip.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And
get over there.
That slit goes all the way up to her belly button, man. I've never seen that.
All right. Come on over. Let me get a little closer look.
Yeah, a landing strip is for a fucking 747.
You like her puss there?
Yeah, she got nice little fat lips on it. And
you want us to get her in the gyno chair for you?
She's got some innies there. Some she should be great. You know, honey, give this thing up. What are you waiting for?
Never seen a clip with cellulite before.
Problems on my mind without having to worry about an unwanted pregnancy or
and that hard on, and the hard on would just go away.
I need more problems.
Unwanted pregnancy, you're through menopause, you dumb fuck.
Yeah.
You can't get pregnant.
I've been going through it for 2 years.
But you can't get pregnant. You can't.
That's it's not impossible. True. You
no, shut the fuck up. Your eggs are fucking like prunes. You have two prunes sitting there.
It tells you to be careful. You can.
No, you can't. You went through menopause. You're done. Mm-hmm. It's over. Your ovaries quit.
Tenure.
They quit the job. They
you
said,
cunt.
Fuck this. I'm
God,
over.
God is not going
to
pass your shit on anybody else.
Process.
What fucking medical? But no, you're an idiot.
Years.
You're an idiot. You're not
it's
getting
true.
Pregnant.
What about blowjobs?
What happened to condoms? Why can't you use a condom?
Yeah, Patty. Yep. You're not getting pregnant.
I got some McCain and some Obama condoms in my purse.
I've always been afraid in the past. Blowjobs.
Well,
what about blowjobs? You ever do that?
No. Never.
No blowjobs? Start with a blowjob. You know what? If she gave David a blowjob, we'd fix everybody today.
Yeah, oh, really? You'll see. Yeah.
It's just... It's.
Let me get these two doing a little porn star film.
Patty looks like Sarah.
Exactly.
It's done. We're going to Buddy Ranch
Patty,
to get back to business.
You're insane. Do you realize you're a crazy person?
No, I'm not.
You
can't I read medical books.
Fucking medical books.
Your hormones are still there.
Your hormones are there. You're fucking... Your egg, your ovaries are not. Your ovaries are not expelling eggs anymore. You're done. You're fucking finished.
She's kept it so long.
Your youth is over.
I don't know if she could fuck at this point. Isn't her pussy closed up like a pierced ear that you don't keep an
earring? You don't put an earring through it or a cock every so often.
Condoms.
Condoms.
You're a condemned house.
Barrier protection. Barrier protection works. Girls don't get pregnant at the ranch.
Fuck a condom. Oh. What? If you get AIDS, you'll be dead before it kills you anyway. Because you're an old bag as it is.
You're outside
you're not
of the
gonna
AIDS
get a
window.
Fucking, you're not going to get pregnant because your fucking eggs are done.
Look at if you're really concerned about getting pregnant. Mm-hmm. So you start with anal.
Yeah, do it up the ass.
Yeah, how about up the ass, Patty?
Start with
I've
what
never
do you think?
Done that.
You've never done anything.
You've never done anything.
They could never even complete a gynecology exam on me because the instrument hurt when they go in, and I almost pass out.
I love
then
Patty right now.
Oh, tell us more.
I love
Patty.
Why would they check it? What could be wrong? It's never been used.
I
know.
So you've never had a complete gynecological exam?
Because they've tried the
you
gynecologists
not even be a woman.
Have tried. Oh, I am.
At this point, she needs a geological exam.
I definitely am.
We're starting you with anal.
For Pat.
Yeah, can we stick a finger in your ass today, Patty?
How about a finger? We'll check your prostate, okay?
We got clubs. We got clubs and everything. Who wants, Dennis, you want to stick a finger
absolutely.
In there? All right, Dennis will stick a finger in your ass.
Yeah, how about that, Patty?
Get the gloves and the lubricant.
Just to get
gloves,
an idea
a little
feeling.
Lube. And he'll stick one of his meaty fingers up your ass.
Yeah. Go with the thumb, Dennis.
She looks like Sarah Palin.
Oh, don't worry.
Well, that's Sarah Palin.
She looks like her.
Yeah. She acts officially. Like her son. Right, sorry.
Someone put a finger up her ass.
Tell me the truth.
You don't want to have sex.
David?
Thank you.
All right, there's the gloves.
All right, Patty, okay, you gotta take your pants off.
Patty, yeah,
she's gonna do it. Gosh, she's
my God,
she's a whore.
She'll do anything.
I love Patty right now. Patty is so much more compelling in her virginity,
sure,
than all this sex that's being thrown around like peanut butter in a fucking cafeteria of a prison.
That's right. If this goes well, we're gonna shove the dildo up her ass, Dennis. So.
What is they just handed me? Juicy Lube.
Yeah, Juicy Lube. It's one of our sponsors. Just say, you love the Juicy Lube.
Well, you know what? We use ID at the ranch. It's an excellent
sponsor. Other shows have, GM as a sponsor. We have Juicy Lube. So. All right, Patty, take your pants off. This is going to be...
Turn around.
This will definitely be weird.
Yeah.
Don't worry about it.
Everybody does it every so often.
How do you want to do this so no one sees? But you got to, expose your ass to Dennis so he could, pop that.
Just do it in front of Dennis. Turn around.
Yeah.
Keep turning.
I know.
There you go. Just like that. Just like that.
So fucking gross.
And you're going to have to bend over, Patty.
Yeah, Amy will help you out.
Bend over.
All right, Dennis just spanked her, obviously.
Oh, goodness gracious.
Ooh. Nice little keister.
What? Yeah. Jimmy thinks she has a nice ass, too, by the way.
Jimmy's
a fan of Patty's ass.
Be gentle.
All right, here we go. Yeah,
don't
move, Patty.
We like lube. We like
squeal. You could squeal, but don't jump.
Oh, my God. Dennis is already, he's lubing
it
up.
Tight.
Where are we going for?
Oh my God.
Sandy Kane, get here.
Should we try the little pussy too at the same time?
Yeah, go ahead.
That works out real well.
Yeah.
See, that stimulates a girl.
Oh my God. Is it good? You like it? That's weird. A little bit? Turn you on, honey?
Should we just start with a little bit?
Oh my God. That's good.
I'm going to be born again, Kristen.
Oh, my God. It's just the weirdest sensation I've ever felt in my life.
But you know what? It's opening it up.
Now you know where it all leads.
Is it?
Yeah.
It's getting big. Yeah. Oh, my God.
Is your mouth getting wet and juicy?
No, but I feel it
hard.
You know,
does it feel good, Patty?
Starting to swell up.
Does it feel good, Patty?
It feels very interesting.
But by that, does that mean good?
Yeah, I guess.
All right.
I think remember, Patty,
Jesus is watching.
All right, look at Patty's getting fucking fingered.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
She's very tight.
Amy, help her through this.
Oh,
Patty, bend over a little more.
No,
bend over a little bit more.
No, I don't, because I'm... Oh, my God.
Just a little. Just listen to them. They know they're pros.
Yeah.
They'll make you feel good.
I'm not a whore, that's for sure.
Well, of course not.
I'm not
that. Don't worry about that. Of course not.
No, you have all your dignity intact.
Don't worry.
No, you got to go to the prom with a corsage and a white dress.
That's right.
You're no whore.
If you still...
She sounds like a chimp.
Yeah, right. Stop it!
Oh, you sexy fucking girl, you.
I think I've had enough.
Really?
I think I've had enough.
Why?
I've had enough.
Patty, always stop before you come.
You got an orgasm?
Did you come?
I just feel a very... It's like a sensation similar to... The vibrator, I guess. I don't know.
You know what?
Bend over, Patty. Bend over. It's for your own good.
Yeah, bend over a lot.
Oh,
we're trying to get the Holy Ghost out of you. Just bend over.
Oh, my God.
Patty. Patty, put your hands on Amy's knees and bend over that way. Go ahead. Just like that. There you go.
Get comfortable.
Now you're talking.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. No, oh God. No. Her arms are shaking. Oh, my God.
All right. Now let's get the black guy to sneak up behind her and shut his cock in.
Stop!
All right.
Stop!
Patty! Patty!
What?
We switched it out for a dick. You're being fucked right now.
No, I'm not! Oh, no, you didn't.
Oh, no, you didn't.
She likes it in the ass more than she likes her titties being played with.
Oh,
isn't that interesting?
God.
Wow, Patty's ready to rock here.
What do you know?
All right, relax, Patty, relax.
Make believe no one's here.
The wiffle ball bat's next, Patty.
Oh.
Oh, my God.
Oh, please. No.
Please more?
Please make
more. Give me more, Daddy.
I suppose.
No, I'm getting tears now.
I suppose it could be interpreted in such a way.
Oh, my God.
All right, good.
Oh, my God.
All right, she's starting to cry.
I think I'm
fine.
Oh, she's good. She's done. Oh, you're done? Did that feel good, Patty?
Oh, my God.
Ew, look at her.
Oh, the panties are all wet. Wow.
Oh, my goodness.
Hey, Patty, let me be the first to say you're a dirty fucking whore.
Say. Let's hear it for the dirty, filthy whore, everyone. Fast forward 3 months, she's Dennis's top girl at the
top
ranch.
Girl, right.
We'll be
fuck you, I want to get paid.
We'll be selling this glove on eBay.
Yeah, the Patty fucking asshole cunt glove.
I would just throw the glove away.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Hey, it's literal Patty. All right.
Yeah.
We got, now, Patty. Honestly, now really think about this. Mm-hmm. How did that feel for you? And don't just say interesting. Give us a little more in-depth. How did that feel?
It felt like he really went into me. You
yeah? It. Did, was it enjoyable?
I'll tell you how you know. When they start pushing back into you a little bit, that's when they know they like
pushing.
It. That in other words, give me a little bit more. And you did that. So I think you enjoyed
you
it.
You were pushing back a little bit?
Yeah.
Kind of wanted a little more,
well,
right?
It was actually involuntarily.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Did it feel good, Patty? Did you enjoy the sensation?
The sensation was very similar to, you know...
A vibrator.
Like what you do.
But Patty, you know what I wonder is, like, wasn't it more the attention you were getting? Wasn't it more that you were the center? So you
no.
had a woman talking in your ear, a guy's finger in your ass, and everybody watching
Thank
and
you,
applauding.
Dr. Ruth.
I think that's more.
I don't think so.
A woman
it
talking
was
in
the
she's
experience.
A lonely woman and she likes the attention.
A woman talking in her ear, a guy with a finger in her ear.
it was more the experience.
Patty, if you decide to keep your virginity.
Yeah.
Taught properly, you can have just as many, if not more, orgasms anally than you can vaginally.
Oh, there you go, Patty. Open up that asshole for business. Yeah.
Just make sure you have a clean ass, though.
Yeah.
Your asshole is a cornucopia.
All right.
Patty, can we throw
shit and orgasms?
Patty, can we throw some splooge on you? Just to make
oh,
the experience.
Oh, no, you already did that.
Yeah,
that's
a little boring.
They already did.
You want to suck someone's dick?
Yeah, we didn't throw real splooge on
you. Why? You're a whore. You might as well start sucking cock.
No, I think I went as farther than I've ever gone before.
Yeah, all right, William
but
Shatner.
You know what? It's nice to explore, isn't it?
Huh? It's interesting.
This is what Christopher Columbus said before he got to America.
Is that what he said?
Same thing.
Did he say it's nice to explore?
Yeah.
Or did Christopher Columbus say, put a finger in my ass?
Pull my hair.
Call me a bitch.
So, Patty, you liked the sensation, is what I'm saying.
Judge, make the witness answer the question,
How
please.
How do you not fucking answer that? What? Be honest. Just be honest.
Well, I'm embarrassed.
Yeah, I know you're embarrassed, but you don't have to be. It felt good. That's part of what feels good with sex, with sex, is people doing things to that area like that. So did it feel good to you? If it did, just,
you can admit it. You can admit it.
Yeah,
honey.
It kind of did.
Yeah.
And I'm embarrassed to say it.
Why are you embarrassed?
Well, because she's a virgin.
Fucking about people have been doing this forever.
Yeah,
what makes
but I
it
don't
embarrassing?
Want people to hate me now.
Why are people going to hate you? Because you're a filthy, dirty skank box.
Yeah. Not.
They're going to like you. They're going to like you more.
They'll
you
like
know
you
why?
More. You're fuckable
you're
now.
You're open-minded and you're a trooper.
You're open
and
to acid.
We had fun with open ass. Yeah.
Acid.
It said acid.
It's still acid on her.
I wouldn't mind reading that book.
Oh.
I really would.
That book, Patty.
Patty, it's a handwriting analysis book, you dummy.
Oh, it says sex, lies, and handwriting.
Well, you're just copy of swank. You could bleed off.
Obviously, you are because. You've had it in the ass now. I want Amy to teach you how to suck dick. She can show you. You can put it in your mouth.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Can you show her, Amy?
Of course I can.
Show some pointers.
With that dildo, you're going to show us how you suck dick.
Mm-hmm. But I've never done it.
All right, give it a try.
You got the best right here. You got the teacher.
Yeah, it's not
right.
All right, there you go. It's stuck on the table.
And what?
Yeah, make her suck the big black one.
We're going to have a blow dart. Yeah.
The chocolate one.
Should she be on her knees for this? How are you going to do this, Amy? No. Okay.
All right, there you go, Patty. Right,
Amy's got one. You've got the other one. Come on over here.
Yeah, we're going to...
What you do is let's put your mouth on it and just lick it. Lick it around here. Up and down
the
shaft. The that's what guys like. They like a little licking. It's like...
Get a bunch of saliva
okay.
into your tongue like this.
So, Patty...
Mm-hmm. Make bubbles. Yeah.
Go ahead, Patty.
Bubbles.
Do it up. We want her to get sloppy.
Hey, Amy,
is America's cocksucker. She's the best. So she's going to teach you how to do this. And but you make bubbles. Go like this. Look at. Okay. Got to have some lubricant. Got to have some lubricant to lubricate that big thing.
Yeah.
Now, now put your mouth on it, just like that. Just lick the end of it.
Oh my God.
Just lick the end of it.
She wants to swallow that dick so bad.
She will.
She's ridiculous.
Just lick it, baby. Come on.
This innocence.
Put it in your mouth, honey. Just lick it just a little bit.
Make, and watch what I'm doing.
Make me happy,
you
honey.
Look me in the eyes.
Give her the basics first. A blowjob, you don't blow it.
You gotta look him in the eye, okay? You
always look him in the eyes.
Always look at eye, cocksucker.
Now just put your mouth on it. Go ahead, baby.
You can Patty.
Put your mouth on it just for a second, okay?
Come on.
But if you don't do it, if you keep holding like that, the
Patty,
cat's
going to
take your head and
Patty, 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 Patty,
Patty, Patty, Patty, Patty, Patty, Patty, Patty, Patty, Patty, Patty, Patty, Patty, Patty, Patty, Patty,
Dude, she just licked it like a kitten licks like milk, just like just barely getting the tongue inside.
Try it again. Watch Amy. Watch Amy while you're doing this. Go down on a little bit more.
Do it. It's not a real dick,
just
dummy.
Stick your tongue out. Stick your tongue out, baby.
Take your tongue.
Stick your tongue out.
Stick it out and just lick it.
It's not real. It's not real. It's like a toothbrush.
There you go. That's it. That's a good girl.
There you go.
Keep going. Keep going.
Just stick your tongue out like this. Now look at me. You gotta watch me, okay?
There you go. Now take it down to your liver, whore. Come on. Get your mouth on that.
Get in there.
Put
Patty.
Your fucking mouth over the head, you
I
fucking
think
bitch.
I'm get sick.
Suck that cock.
See, if you don't put it in your mouth, they grab
you.
The back of your head
yeah,
and force
you.
Yeah.
It, they make
you don't
want to
be forced. You're going to choke.
That's what you want.
Amy, force it. Force it.
Force that.
Have Patty gag on that cock.
You suck that black cock.
While you were doing. He liked it. Didn't he turn you on a little bit?
Jimmy, you missed
it.
It gave me a little heartburn.
Jimmy, Dennis just fingered Patty in the ass, and
Jimmy missed the whole fucking thing.
Can you can you do it again for Jimmy, Patty?
It wasn't pleasant. Did you really? You fingered with those big meat hooks?
He fucking. Bowling ball. Patty. Jimmy missed it. For
I
Jimmy.
Did miss it. I was on
and
the
Annie had a couple in her pussy, too. Yeah, and his HBO show starts tonight, Down and Dirty, and, this is a present to Jimmy.
It's a big day
for me. It's a big day for him and his HBO show.
Jimmy's been so good to you over the years.
Yeah, you might as well completely
ruin
my day.
Get another glove.
In fact, Jimmy, we'll do it together.
All right.
Yeah.
How about that, Patty?
Yeah, come on, Patty.
You all right there, Patty?
Patty,
how are you feeling?
Jimmy will take a hole and Dennis will...
You feel sick with that.
What do you mean, with the suck and the fucking dildo?
Well,
how does that make you feel sick? It didn't come?
It's got a bad latex taste to it, isn't it?
Does it?
And she was gagged on an anthem.
Yeah, her face is being pushed down on it like a whore hand on the back of her head.
Yeah,
a
whore hand pushing her. All right, Jimmy's putting his glove on. Dennis Hoff is putting his glove on.
Here we go.
This could be an HBO event.
Filling up every hole.
Please. I'm warming up here. You got to curl the fist and get the twist.
I don't want to be on camera.
No, don't worry about it.
Nobody wants you on
camera. It's very private.
What do you think it's going to go up on www.?
It's a very private thing. It's not to be filmed.
It is.
It's very intimate and quiet.
Have a donut, Lil.
Have a donut. Put that in there, too. You want a Dunkin' Munchkin up your ass?
Turn your own side. We want to get you close to the microphone because I want you, when you start coming, I want everybody to hear your first orgasm.
Right.
How come you get the? Why do I get the asshole?
Because I've already been there, dude.
What?
Now, what
am I dying?
That's what Bonnie Voss said at the altar.
We're gonna do it.
We're gonna do it.
He could have been quicker.
You want the front or the back?
Patty, where would you rather? Because Dennis has bigger fingers. Where would you prefer to have me?
I don't know.
Front or back?
Front or back? Just say front or back.
You got more lube?
It's all just a nightmare. Yeah. You want to flip a coin?
I love
flip
ID.
A coin.
Heads, flip a coin.
Heads, we both lose.
Yeah, but where do you want to be, buddy?
She can't
make a decision. You can't make a decision.
I'll take the asshole.
Thank you.
All right.
And I'm a fucking trooper.
All right. Jimmy's taking
the
asshole.
Trooper.
I've already kicked you off for you.
You're a pooper
right,
trooper.
So pull those pants down.
All right. Here we
you
go.
You did a good job, sucker.
Might as well throw those out
for
a
first timer.
They ain't hurting.
First time.
Yeah, she how many times do you see this woman's
she got
ass today?
Ass on her.
She does.
Patty likes that.
Because I take care of myself.
All right, we know. You got good hygiene, we heard. Yeah. Do you shave every day?
Not every day. I don't think I need to.
Why do you shave, by the way?
Because
The hair's gray.
Hair's gray.
Oh,
shit.
I thought that was going to be something. Why did you ask that? Hold on. Pull your pants down. You might have an orgasm. That makes it hotter, right? Frederick Douglass with an axe wound.
What's wrong, Jimmy?
I want Captain Kangaroo Pussy to pull her pants down a little further.
All right, you gotta lose the pants, Patty.
Pull them down a little bit more.
You gotta lose the pants.
At least push them down to those orthopedic sneakers.
Yeah, there
Jimmy,
she goes.
It's been a long time since we did this together.
Yeah, it really has been a while.
Yeah, 54-year-old.
There we go. Right.
How many years since we fingered a retard?
Oh, shit.
I'm kidding, Patty.
Good. All right.
There it goes.
Jimmy's working the ass.
Oh, my God, no.
Hold on. Will you stop it? I'm just getting in there. Will you stop? Oh my God. I want to get something out of this. You will. You're going to get something out of this. YouTube video.
Oh, God.
You know what?
Jim's going to get something out of it. Some diarrhea on his finger.
Relax, baby. I'm going to make you come.
Oh, God.
It's going to be your first orgasm with a man.
No.
The first orgasm with a man.
Yes. Oh, God.
Yes.
Yes.
Relax.
No. Say yes. Think in your head that you want it. Yes. No,
you want it. Just think about a big cock inside you. Huh?
Jimmy, why don't you moving your finger, Jimmy?
Star. I am. I'm actually
Who's your favorite movie star?
All right.
How's
that asshole, Jimmy? How's it feel? Tight?
Yeah.
Stick your dick in. Go ahead.
Squeeze it.
It's like a sparrow's eye.
Oh, God.
Okay, feels right? Good, Patty?
Don't stick your stomach out. See, you pull
feel,
it in, honey.
The clit's getting real big. You feel it? Like when you use your use the vibrator, right?
Pull in that stomach, honey. Perfect. Pull it in. Suck it in.
Squeeze your stomach hard. But you squeeze your stomach and then you let it go.
Squeeze your kegel.
Oh,
shit. Squeeze your kegel. Like you're holding off your pee.
You're close, baby.
Shut
it off. You feel it.
You're
going
to come.
Huh?
No, Patty. I think I'm Patty.
No, Patty, you can do this.
Because you're going to come. Don't let it. Don't make it stop. Do it. Go roll with it.
You can do this.
It's going to be good. You're going to fall. I'm on your knees, man.
You can do this.
Oh, help.
All right, let's listen in. Go ahead.
Oh, my God.
There you go.
Yes. No,
does no mean yes or no mean quit?
Well, she said
no means I love it. What are you telling
me?
It feels weird, but you like it, don't you?
Oh huh? My God!
God, I hope you know
how many girls have
seen this. Hey, Patty! Patty!
What?
You want to put that the smaller dildo up there?
No. I'm not ready for that sound.
No.
Oh, my God.
Are you ready to come, baby?
Oh,
I want to hear you come.
God.
That turns a man on. If you come, Jimmy and I will get the hardest Chinese arithmetic, okay?
She's out.
You can hear it, aren't you?
The Chinese arithmetic. Yes. Huh?
Yes.
Oh, God. Yes. Oh, I think I've had enough. Yes. Oh, my God. I've had enough.
Do you see that, Ant?
Oh, yeah. No,
she's
more.
Tapping her foot, she's tapping like Abbey Road is playing.
Oh my God!
It's so weird.
Oh my
tapping
God!
Tapping her little foot to the rhythm of the cunt fucking.
No way! No.
Good stuff.
No!
Dennis is asking, should we really stop or Patty?
Was that good?
We're just standing here.
Patty, what do you want?
I think I want to end it.
I think Patty had an orgasm.
The gruesome fingering has ended.
I think she came.
Patty was getting very
tears in my eyes.
That's why you came.
Me and
you
both had an orgasm.
So do we.
These are the freedoms we're fighting for.
Tears in her eyes, I guess, as she wipes off her panties.
Patty, I gotta say, your asshole is quite the little guppy. It was like a little guppy mouth gripping my finger.
Really?
Yeah, it was like a little bird chicklet.
Little tight thing. Patty, your eyes are tearing tight. Like you.
Come here, baby.
You came, didn't you?
Give me a hug.
Did you feel an orgasm there, Patty? No. What did it feel
I
like?
I know I felt something.
Yeah, huh?
I think it was a finger in your ass and a finger in your twat.
Yeah.
She could squeeze it real, real tight. So that feels, she had an orgasm.
Patty, do you realize you can make some money at the ranch more than you make, you know, fucking coffee?
In Starbucks?
Yeah.
You can stop by here and
if anyone's looking
Jimmy
for a dried up old bag.
Send over the desk.
Yeah.
It's got to be somebody's fantasy.
Somebody, yes.
A pussy that doubles in a candy dish.
Wants an Old West style whore.
Guys, you know what we should do? Just for your website. Mm-hmm. We should take Patty as she is and let me put her through the Bunny Ranch
the whore training
program and see what she looks like in a month. Believe me.
Oh, wow.
Right hair.
A glazed
makeup,
donut?
Right clothes. You'd see a whole different chick here.
She believe wouldn't me have to fuck, though, right? Because she's too nervous to fuck.
Mm-hmm. She don't have to do anything she doesn't want to. Nobody. No,
no,
sure,
no,
right,
no,
right.
There's probably guys that would pay to just jerk off while she stands there going, what are you doing?
Why? Oh, my God. That's I've never disgusting seen that. Would you just watch a guy jerk off and, like, comment on, ew, what is that? That'd be funny to
have
do.
You ever
I
give
think
a lap dance?
Wouldn't that be hysterical? All of a sudden, you just blow your load.
35, just for the hell of it.
Oh, yeah. I know. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Channel 35. And what do you see? Yeah. Do they show up?
All I see is one commercial after another, right? And then I have been watching that show for years. That fat blonde chick does. I, you know, what's her name again?
Wow, she's babbling.
Bob Kelly?
Must have been a good
no
one.
No, it's a lady. Once in a while, lady. I turn
exactly
to her
literal
show. Robin Bird.
Oh, Robin
get
Bird.
Get comfortable if you don't have anybody to, you know, be with, we'll be with you or
oh,
something.
Oh, so then you pull
says
out the vibrator and you start doing yourself
no,
a little bit.
But I just no, watch the dancing and stuff.
You watch the dancing.
Oh, she's a lesbian.
She's good, very
Patty, you're
skilled
a lesbian,
dancer.
Huh?
No, I'm
yes
not.
Yeah, you are.
You're not a lesbian?
No, I'm
watching
not
the dancing, the naked girls dancing.
You don't like...
Well, there's guys that dance, too.
Oh, yeah. They're
I
called homosexuals.
Yeah. I don't know.
Yeah, well, yeah, well why would you? Well.
How'd that feel, Patty?
I'm so glad we were able to confuse her even more.
Did you like
oh, I know.
That
she's
bit
a mess.
Yeah, it's okay.
Yeah, I'm embarrassed.
There's
yeah
no need to be embarrassed.
I know,
you fucking
you
had an orgasm.
You get to be embarrassed the
it's
first
just
time somebody
O&A
fingers your asshole on the
friends
radio.
Yeah.
If you do
that's
it 5 minutes later, you don't get to pretend you're embarrassed. If somebody fingers your asshole, somebody fingers your asshole in front of bleachers of people,
yeah,
and you go, ugh, I shouldn't have done that. I'm so embarrassed. But yeah, if you do it 5 minutes later, you can't go, oh, wow, what did I just do again? Yeah. What did I go and do again?
That's an excellent point.
Yeah. My judgment never seems to improve. So I didn't know how I would feel, even though it just happened.
Louis C.K. nailed it.
All right, Pat from Munaki, your turn. Step up to the table. All right, Pat, bend over.
What?
Jimmy's going to put his thumb up your ass.
Yeah. No, I'm just going
to... Oh, he's going to pull out on his thumb like a little
facetious
fucking... A little hot dog from Nathan's that was left in
hey,
the
Pat,
colon.
Was that hot watching Stalker Patty get a little action there?
Oh, yeah, that was... really hot.
Yeah.
My stocks aren't the only thing that's down.
Oh, his penis. Penis trying to tie
him
with the stock joke.
Oh, no.
Jeez. I think the only thing...
There's no debate over whether that was funny or not.
The only thing hotter than that was the last breath of JonBenet Ramsey.
Hey, I was there for that.
Too far?
Yeah.
Oh, that's lying, but I was there for that. It's pretty funny.
Too soon?
Jim, the question is, should we bring Pat along with the circus? When
Pat, what do you think?
I would like to have Pat along.
Take that limp dick along.
That
and
sounds like funny. How long is that?
That sounds like funny.
What kind of animals you got?
I got a doggie and three cats.
So why don't you just
a lot of peanut butter.
Kissing it, look at that. Hey, see, look at that.
Why don't you get someone to take care of your fucking shitty animals and you go out to the bunny ranch?
Oh, that sounds like fun.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah, you don't make it sound like fun,
yeah,
though.
Know.
You're like, oh,
really
that sounds
fun.
Like...
I'm nervous.
How about you can take a fucking Viagra or a Cialis when you're out there to override your diabetes.
Okay.
And you have fun.
Diabetes.
Yeah.
Going out to the bunny ranch and get fucked. Diabetes.
Hey, is Don Wicklin out there? I saw
Patty's
him.
Patty's pussy looks like my mustache.
David Gray.
That's good.
Wow. Nothing.
David. David.
David?
David.
David?
David. My intern.
Yeah, David.
Thanks
David
for bringing me breakfast. And no jerking off before you come to the Bunny Ranch.
David.
Okay. All right,
David. Area of Area 51. That's right, with the aliens in the ship. You knew then. You did nothing. Be dead if it wasn't for my son, David.
Over the top fucking idiot.
Where's Don
Wicklin? Judd Hirsch.
Bring Don Wicklin in here.
You need some soup.
God. You know, I tell you, it just keeps going through my mind. When I first walked in here, Norton says to me, Dennis, we can't do the stuff we used to do.
Right.
And, what the fuck?
Oh, I'm saying the hardcore, like we can't fuck.
Yeah. We can't kill.
Hardcore.
Yeah.
Yeah, we can't kill the people.
We just need to pee this chick, Jimmy.
Wow. Well, you know. Well, look who's here. An executive.
Hey, Don,
thank you from the company.
Thank you for letting us finger Patty on two satellite radio services. We greatly appreciate that.
That's okay. Gloves were used.
Yeah, you know.
Consenting adults.
Sure.
One retard. Did you guys touch fingers? Were you able to feel each other's fingertips?
No, I like that.
That feeling is really cool.
No, you ever
make the okay sign with the one thumb and the stink and one in the touch. Pink and the pink regular pointer finger?
Mm-hmm.
And then you touch together and go, oh, I could feel my thumb.
Mm. Yeah.
What's going on in there?
And you actually say it to her in that tone of voice.
Yeah. I can feel my thumb.
Oh, interesting.
Ooh,
goes, what are you
point.
Doing?
Little
and then she goes, my mommy's coming home. It could be trouble.
And you go, I know, I'm married to her.
Then the girl looks at Jimmy and says, have you met Chris Hansen?
Ruining it. Yeah.
Oh, well.
Very hard to follow up a grand slam like that.
Yeah, no kidding. Why don't we start the wrap-up process here?
All right.
Want to congratulate Don on his dumb promotion.
Congratulations.
So what are you now?
Yeah, what
I
are
have
you?
No idea. It's
yeah.
The same shit I was doing before.
You just got a different title, right?
That's all.
Yeah.
And we're still a lot of finger chicks on our show, right?
Sure, absolutely.
All right. Good to know.
Nice.
All right.
Like that. You can take the big black cock if you want.
Yeah.
Oh, no, you want that
all
one.
Right.
I know. All right.
You can make believe you're cleaning up the studio.
Just helping out. I'll take this.
What? I was putting it in my back pocket. to dispose of it.
I need to rid this place of this filth.
Jesus.
Oh, my God.
I leaned forward for it, too.
That's hysterical. Oh, you guys.
What does this guy do for you guys?
Lounged up. Nothing.
Nothing.
No, we're kidding. I have no idea. I'm not sure what Don Wicklund does. Actually, he helps me if I go, so-and-so needs a radio turned on.
Yeah.
And then he's able to do that. Up until the merger, and then, boy, they weren't going for fucking dick, were they?
No.
Jesus Christ. Well, I had a bunch of people call me up going, my radio doesn't work anymore. Actually, it was, my radio doesn't work anymore.
Yeah. Of course. My radio doesn't work. Well, fucking pay for it.
Yeah, exactly.
My radio doesn't work.
Oh,
I'll make a call.
Right. I'll write a check.
Let me see if I can help you. If not, I'll hand you cash at the end. Can you say sugar daddy? I like those words.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
You don't know what you're doing?
No idea.
No. But he's got the fucking BlackBerry out and he's scrolling,
right.
So there's important shit going on.
Dennis, you know what you were just doing with Patty?
Yes.
That's what XM's been doing at Don for a very long time. So it's good to know that they did the right thing.
Norton set his finger up his ass for a while.
Well, that's just what he meant.
Don's been taking it for a while from those fuckers down there.
Well,
and they did
it's
the right
a good thing
and,
you have a sponsor like ID because you need a lot of it around here.
Don, just a couple of people probably, you don't have to mention names, but a couple of people that got the old fucking boot out the door that you're like, good.
Yeah.
Good.
Elo, obviously.
First one on the list.
Start with Elo.
Eric.
Elo. Of course. Fucking backstabbing schmuck he was.
Are you sad that Hugh Panaro's gone?
I am, actually.
Yeah. Why?
He was the first one who started everything.
Started it all, right?
Very diplomatic. How about Nate? Are you sad Nate's gone?
And Hitler started the highway system.
Is Nate still here?
Nothing.
He did. That doesn't change.
He just did. That's history.
Yeah. Yes, he did.
Where's Nate working?
Not sure.
Just because he started it doesn't mean he's a good guy. No. I mean, he was, but
he's good at
I'm just
starting
saying.
Highways.
It's these highways. Yeah. Jesus, come on.
Look, sloppy marching went out the window. All the walkways were shoveled. You know, you think lemons should make fucking lemons?
Hey, Amy's falling asleep there. You all right, Amy?
What's the matter, Amy?
You had a good time?
Need you need another shot of cum?
Another tickle?
Another shot of cum, yeah. Protein.
Another shot of protein. Yeah, because cum has protein.
Yeah.
Yes, it does. It
must be.
Lee, he's got to help you.
Fucking
huh?
great.
Mm-hmm.
You must, when you shit, does it look like Cool Whip?
Like chocolate Cool Whip?
Just like fucking chocolate. Like a parfait. He comes out half and half.
Tastes good, too.
Does it?
Yeah, I'll put it in a plastic bag and give it to you for it to go.
Nice. I'll strap that on like a feed bag and eat your shit. Nice.
You know, Anthony, you joke, but...
That's Jimmy the Scatman.
Oh, yeah, Scatman Jimmy.
Yeah.
Is anybody home?
Doc? Are we going to the same character?
And 20 logs of lamb.
Let's do line of the day and start our weekend. The party at Anthony's house started 10 minutes ago. What are you doing?
I know.
Here?
Well, you know, I'm going to wait for people to get over there, I guess.
All right.
What are we going to do?
Go?
Jimmy, you are so cordially invited.
Hi.
To my house. That fucking jacuzzi heater's going on.
Right.
The beers are all cold. I know you don't drink beers, but there'll be non-alcoholic beverages for you.
Hopefully an iced tea.
Yes, a little iced tea for Jimmy. And maybe, you know, a couple of ladies want to come over.
Ooh.
I'm saying. Got all the rooms now, beds in them and shit like that. It's the Chateau Cumia. There's even a bed in that fucking maid's quarters.
Really?
Fuck her.
There's a fold-out in the cabana.
There's a fold-out in the cabana.
Jesus
Boy,
Christ,
I could fucking bed so many people there. It's ridiculous.
Smart.
Nice.
Can we start a Bunny Ranch annex there?
Yeah, the Bunny Ranch fucking franchise.
Numbers on the doors.
I'm sure Nassau County Police Department would love that one.
Numbers and names on the
Getting
doors.
Those called, my neighborhood's full of fucking
we
Davids. They would love that. What's going on over there next door?
Yes.
Just keep the traffic down, that's all.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's a good
Make
point.
Make them stay for a few days.
Yeah, right.
We weren't serious.
Yeah, we weren't. The cokes were an awful lot.
Yeah. Stick to feeding me bags of shit.
Yeah. Why don't we say hi to
Speaking of bag of shit, Donnie. He's so busy working, he doesn't hear a word I say.
Pay attention, Don. You're on the radio with us. You're hanging with
He's so
boys.
Busy right
what,
now.
You got your first problem as in your new position?
No, everything's running great. His new position, now he's probably like, this is my card. The color is bone. The font is the... Did you get new business cards?
Not yet, no.
Yeah, okay. That's
wild. Don, thanks for adding a lot.
Sure, it'll come out of our fucking budget.
So,
yeah, exactly.
Let's do line of the day. It's time to go.
Line of the day.
Yep. It's brought to you by WebEx. Hold meetings, make presentations, and do it from the comfort of your own home or office. Check it out at webex.com. Here's a runner-up line of the day.
We got the double.
Yes,
on.
You're just showing people that you're
you
not even.
Arrested.
He's making me want to put that white sheet to a better use.
It's funny for us, maybe not the audience.
No, well, they probably wanted to hear more of Puffy's blog. It was funny.
All right.
He didn't go on long enough with the scared
thing. No, he didn't.
Let's do another runner-up line of the day.
Hey, Anthony, we haven't heard from Louis C.K. in a while, Lou.
Hello!
That
was
like a borgasm. Yeah, it was generous.
Louis,
generous. That was a charity fucking line of the day if I ever heard
exactly.
one. Do you motherfuckers do that on purpose? The guest always seems to have a fucking runner up line of the day.
Not
Sometimes the guest sucks.
Yes.
I didn't say Louis sucks.
No,
today.
I did today.
No, actually.
No, you've been killing this.
Louis,
well, that wasn't a good
killing.
One. As far as under the breath comedy goes, you killed today. And I heard every single bit of it.
The Showtime special's tomorrow night, Lou.
That's right.
What time? 11 o'clock?
11 o'clock tomorrow on Showtime.
It's a shitty time slot.
Louis C.K. chewed up.
Oh, what's better? What's a better time?
My show's on 11 o'clock. All right, let's do another runner-up.
Nothing worse than
it's
you...
also on demand starting the day after.
You when you give some good news and some and fucking passive-aggressive comic just makes a shitty remark about it.
Oh, wow. Why didn't they give you a
better...
They try to say it supportively. Why didn't they give you... You should have gotten a much better time slot than that.
Yeah.
Oh, I was actually happy with it.
Well, really?
All right,
runner-up line of the day, another one.
Put it all the way in, just a little bit, like a little bit, like it's your penis. Yeah. Why won't you unzip your fly? What do you have, fucking bees living in there? Yeah, I earned that one.
That was a good one.
Jimmy, tonight, the big night, HBO, Down and Dirty, midnight.
Yeah, and it's...
Are you excited?
I don't know. I'll be more excited next week after I've done TV for it, because... You know, I do Leno and Chelsea Handler next week, so hopefully that will get more people watching it.
Oh, Leno.
Yeah.
Nice.
A panel, you know how it is.
Tonight's show.
Oh, a little show called
Leno. Jay, you know what's funny, Jay? Hookers! Hookers and shit on my mouth! Nothing prepared.
You're going to kill Jimmy.
Oh, of course you
I'm
will.
I'm fucking finished.
Another runner-up line of the day.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
Is your mouth getting wet and juicy?
No, but I feel it.
Hard?
You know,
does it feel good, Patty?
Starting to swell up.
Does it feel good, Patty?
It feels very interesting.
But by that, does that mean good?
Yeah, I guess.
All right.
I think remember, Patty
Jesus
over.
Is watching.
Who said Jesus is watching?
Pat from Wanaki.
That's a runner-up line of the day. All right.
I'm gonna send Patty. I'm gonna send Patty a Bunny Ranch robe so she can wear around the studio every week she's here.
Oh, that'd be nice. Old Titan 1B head. Wow, that bombed as much as a Titan 1B rocket.
Oh, Titan? I think he meant tight in.
No. See, he's got a head that's very bullet shaped.
Oh.
Very rocket shaped. That's what I like doing, going out on a Friday with a bomb. Just forget everything I did all week and remember that one. Yeah,
send everybody to that fucking weekend with a tinfoil taste in their mouth. The fucking worst.
1B bomb.
Better than a copper taste in your mouth.
Yeah, no. Could be.
Or onion. Ooh, let's do that thought.
Let's do line of the day.
Hit it. Balls, right?
Yes, of course. Balls.
Comes. Line of the day. Would you ever go to the Bunny Ranch?
Nobody can hear his shrug.
I would.
He's fucking making a noise. It's radio.
I would.
You fucking
he
Jew.
Shrugs. I would.
There's a little improv stand-up for you.
There you go. Louis right. C.K., everyone. Line of the day. Yes.
And Dennis, what's the big plug? What are we trying to tell the people tonight? What's the big plug, Dennis Hoff?
Well, you, October 23rd, HBO, Cat House, 11 o'clock. Yeah. And also, they're putting out the DVD set, finally. Two seasons
nice.
And the musical we did, which was wonderful. And so, you know, buy the stuff. Stay. You can jerk off to it at home. It's great.
And Amy, anything?
BunnyRanch.com, AirForceAmy.com.
Yeah. And fifth blowjob on the way, right?
Undoubtedly. Who wants to be the next victim for 5 days?
I like to just watch. I want to see Lee get his fucking long penis worked on. That fucking hat.
Oh, speaking of which, Jimmy, we're going to work on a cuckold situation live.
Oh, God, yeah, we want to.
I forgot about that. We got to start pushing that.
We want to get a fucking cuckold in here. Not looking at any of you. But it's we want to get a guy who's a real cuckold who likes to watch his wife get fucked.
By the bull.
By a bull. And we want to get a bull, preferably a black bull, so there's a whole racial thing going. And we're going to hopefully that the cuckold will have to watch his wife service the bull.
Mm-hmm.
That's a noble purpose.
Yeah, you know.
If the cuckold wants to prep the bull,
certainly.
That is the business of the cuckold.
We're not going to say
one
no.
One down on Wall Street.
What's that, Pat?
The bull on Wall Street.
God. Would you stop with your fucking stock jokes?
Just
I didn't even hear it.
They stink.
You know what? Let me bring Ron Jeremy in, my bitch, for that job.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Nah, but Ron is he's a problem. Hey, you know what, Ron?
Might work.
He's a problem.
Here's the problem. He's got a 10-inch dick. All right, no problem.
It could work. The nice thing about Ron is that he can fuck with all these people watching. Most guys can't. Yeah. You had a hard time with it. You know, I'm not real comfortable with it, but Ron can. I mean, he can. You know, Ron wants to. He'll fuck on a bus with full of people. I mean, he doesn't care.
All right. Yeah, that's actually not a bad idea. But we want to see Ron's almost too fun to be a bull.
Mm-hmm.
Like he's a funny guy, silly.
Yeah.
Like you want a guy who's a real cuckold and a guy who's a real fucking
somebody slap her around and handcuff her.
Yeah,
and all that.
Like
yeah.
But the real arrangement, like the real people that do that shit. Like you know.
Okay, I think I can handle that.
All right, Dennis, thank you.
Thank
Amy,
you.
It's
thank
always
you.
Fun, guys.
Audience, thank you. 4 years of this radio thing.
Well, yeah. Is it 4 years this weekend?
4 years tomorrow, officially, was our first show back.
Happy anniversary. Ron.
Yeah. You know, I'll tell you, I'm so glad
exactly.
You guys are back.
Are you?
I missed you, and you know, I motherfucked everybody when that happened. That was an awful thing. I actually, because of you, canceled my
so
deal.
So, you liked the show?
I canceled XM.
What did you like about the show before we got...
Dude,